Fridley. Fridley, Minnesota, garden spot of the Midwest. Well, I hope my guitar ain't all tuned up this morning. I'm afraid I was so cold I left it in the car all night. I'm afraid it got tuned. No, it's all right. Yeah, it's fine. How about this snow? See the weather we're having out here right now? That's the same type of weather they got up north where them baby seals is living. That's what they got. These baby seals, they love it. If we had one of them seals here, he'd love it. He'd go out there to the parking lot and swim around laughing and screaming. He'd love it. Yeah. For the next 3 weeks, we're going to be on you to sign in petitions. I want to thank you so much for calling and getting in petitions. We're going to get them out in the mail to you today or tomorrow at the very latest. You should have them by Monday. A lot of people getting theirs already if they called in earlier in the week, don't you know? We're going to have them petitions out to you. Get them signed and get them back here. We're going to save them baby seals. Rex King loves you. Other than that, I want to thank everybody. I want you to keep them cards and letters coming in about my program here. Keep them cards and letters coming in to Rex King. Why? Because the station's running out of Charmin. That's why.
Wow! You're going to be taken by the man, dude.
Clear. Hold it. Clear to partly sunny through the Mari with local blowing and drifting snow. Oh, my goodness. My wife was talking to me last night about going up to Lover's Lane, don't you know? Got a Lover's Lane around here? So where's everybody go to park? Back in my hometown in Poughkeepsie, where my wife is from, we used to go courting. I remember we used to go up on this high hill. Everybody used to go up there on this hill overlooking the city. Ain't much to look at, but we used to go up there everywhere. I remember one time we was there. I had a convertible. We put the top down in the car. We was sitting there getting ready to smooch and everything. My wife says, ain't it beautiful up here? It's so clear and the air smells so good. And listen to all them crickets chirping. I says, they ain't crickets. They're zippers. What are you... This morning on the way to work, everybody be careful there because the roads is just terrible. Yes, indeed. The big highways is okay, but little old roads is bad. Everybody be careful there. People slipping and sliding all over the place. I did manage to get to a bar last night over there in Fridley. I had to go to one of my favorite watering holes because a buddy of mine was having a birthday and everybody was celebrating over to the bar. It was a wonderful party, don't you know? Wonderful party. There was about 40 of us over there despite the snow. They had a bunch of beer there. Everybody was sucking on grain belts all night long, eating tater chips and slime and everything. It was wonderful. Playing a little pool, some foosball, shuffleboard. It was just wonderful. Matter of fact, you know what they done had? They had an ice sculpture. You ever seen an ice sculpture? Well, they had one. An ice sculpture of Raquel Welch right there in the middle. You don't believe me? Look, my lips are still frostbitten. High today, around 25, low tonight near 10 degrees. My wife wasn't too happy. I come home last night about 12:30. She says to me, all you ever think about is sex and booze. Don't you know what good, clean fun is? I said, no, what good is it? And windy, 21 degrees in the Twin Cities, 20 degrees in the suburbs, and 61 in Fridley. My wife is just like all women, don't you know, Radio Rangers. My wife is always trying to make me jealous. Probably your wife does the same. She's always saying things to make me jealous and everything, don't you know? Your wife probably does the same thing. Women is all alike. Always trying to make me jealous, thinking that she's hanging around and everything, don't you know? Last night after dinner, she come in there last night and she'd heard that I was playing around with one of the women's in the office and everything. She says to me last night, she says to me, oh yeah, Rex King, well what would you say if I told you I was sleeping with your best friend? I said to her, well, I'd say you're a lesbian, that's what I'd say. Well, it's gonna be so cold there and cold outside. Well, how am I?
Twenty-four past seven. It's Dave DeSeal, St. James. Hi, you. Nice to have you along here. As you head off to work at school this morning, it's going to be crummy. Hazardous driving outside today because of the snow last night and everything. But leave a couple minutes early, all right? Yeah, you're definitely. What is wrong with this?
There you go.
You're definitely going to want to do that. Leave a couple of minutes early today. Let me see. Oh, yeah, I want to tell you. We're not taking any more names for petitions, okay? Don't call the office anymore, please. The reason is, to tell you the honest truth, we're out of them. We had to order petitions 6 times this week, reorder, and we now have ordered 10,000 petitions. Can you dig it? And that's it. I mean, we just can't do anymore, because if we took any more names, it would be at least a week before we got them out to you. And we've got to have the petitions up to the International Fund for Animal Welfare by Christmas time. See, so we're blocked in by a deadline. We will take requests next week for repeat petitions, okay? If your name's already on file with us here and you need some more, you'll get an instruction sheet. You can either Xerox them yourself or call us and we'll send you a couple out. But we're out of them. Don't come out to the station here either to pick them up because we're out of them. I'm telling you, we are out of petitions. And the printers are working as fast as they can, the good people at Instaprints, to get us some more. But we're out of petitions. Okay? And we just thank you so much. We never for a second thought we'd use 10,000 of these things, but we sure did. And we'll get them out to you. You should have them tomorrow or Monday at the latest, you should have these, okay? Is that all squared away? Okay. What an incredible thing. 21 degrees outside, windy but gorgeous out there. Be careful on the way to work. Like we said, hazardous driving warnings are out. 27. U100 Save the Seals time with St. James in the morning and playing the hits while you're spraying your pets. How you? Want to remind you, tonight we have not canceled out. I will still be at the Cottage Grove Cheapskate. A couple of people have called already to find out if we're still going to be there. Absolutely. We'll be there from, when will I be there? 7 o'clock tonight until 11 for the skating sessions. Come on out to the Cottage Grove Cheapskate. Going to have records and a lot of sealed petitions. We're going to have some turkeys and t-shirts and junk to give away. It's going to be crazy tonight. Jerry Save the Seals, St. James, out of Chicago. And yes, someone here does know what time it is. That's his job. Our official timekeeper here at U100 is Moose, and the official time. At the sound of the tone here, Moose. Me. Thank you so much, Moose Face. 29 before 8.
Thank you.
Sports time
thank
on
you.
The radio.
Thank you.
Well,
thank
what's you. Happening sports wise?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Sports-wise this morning in the Twin Cities... Oh, wait a minute. I'm Art Snow, your sportsman for Michael J. Douglas, who is on vacation this morning. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah. Sports-wise in the Twin Cities, our Minnesota Fighting Saints 1-1 last night. Let's hear it. That doesn't happen very often. It happens more often with the Saints, however, than it does with the Minnesota North Stars. Yes, the Saints came out on top last night, beating the New England Whalers by a score of 2-0. And elsewhere in the WHA, Winnipeg over Quebec, 3-2. That's in overtime. Phoenix over Edmonton, 3-1. San Diego over Denver, 5-1. In the National Hockey League, New York Islanders down Boston, 2-2. Or no, they didn't. How can they do that? That's a tie. Buffalo over Detroit, 7-2. Philadelphia over California, 3-2. All that in the National Hockey League. I see what's wrong now. My ticker isn't ticking, and things just don't go right unless your ticker happens to be ticking. Football coach Earl Bruce of Iowa State, rumored to be under fire because of the Big 8 team's five-game losing streak, has received a vote of confidence from the school's athletic council. A construction company spokesman said, whether New York City defaults or not, renovation to Yankee Stadium will be ready in time for the start of the 1976 baseball season coming up next April. And the head of a black business group, credited earlier this week with saving the Virginia Squires franchise, says his firm has no plans to pump money into the ABA franchise, but will loan money to investors instead of that. Andy Messersmith and Dave McNally hope to follow fellow pitcher Catfish Hunter's successful arbitration route in gaining free agent status and bigger salaries. Messersmith, a 19-game winner for the L.A. Dodgers this past season, presents his case to an arbitration panel in New York City today, while McNally, who quit the Montreal Expos back on June 8th, will make his presentation on Monday. Baseball's champion Cincinnati Reds are richer by the tune of 19,000 bills today. That's a share that each of the players got for winning the World Series. The losing Boston Red Sox didn't do too bad either, with the American Leaguers picking up $13,325 apiece. The total players pool for the series and league championships is more than $4.7 million, which will be shared by the players from 13 different teams. Despite losing seasons, Coach John Jardine of Wisconsin and Earl Bruce of Iowa State will probably be back next year. Bruce has received a vote of confidence from his school's athletic council, which I mentioned. Jardine put to rest rumors he's planning to step down at season's end. In other college football news, blowing winds and freezing temperatures forced the Nebraska Cornhuskers indoors yesterday for their last home practice before the Big 8 title clash in Oklahoma. At Columbus, Ohio, Coach Woody Hayes says his Buckeyes are in good shape physically, with every one of his starters expected to play in tomorrow's Big 10 championship game at Michigan. And we're hoping that the weather won't stop the people, and we will fill up the stadium for the last game as the Gophers take on Wisconsin and try to make it a winning season this year. If they can beat Wisconsin, it'll be 6-5 for the season. That's the best possible way to finish. U100 reminds you. Oh, no, U100 Save the Seals weather. That's what I wanted to give you. Okay. Clear to partly sunny through tomorrow is the way it is. Most of this activity in Minnesota is all over with. Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. It's windy out there right now. High today around 25. Low tonight around 10. Now it's 20, and it's cloudy, and it's windy. And I'm Art Snow for Michael J. Douglas with Jerry St. James.
U100 is Spinner's Air in the games that people play. It is 7:38, 22 now, in front of 8 o'clock on the Jerry St. James Save the Seals radio program. Hi, you. Nice to have you along here this morning. Oh, my goodness. Just beautiful outside. It's just gorgeous, but it's also treacherous, hazardous, and slippery, and crummy. So be careful. On the way to work this morning, streets are not in the best of conditions. 35W is okay, but like the other roads, they're not really the best, so watch out. Oh, by the way, the hot flash news of the morning is next for you. U100 with Jerry St. James on the radio, playing the hits while you're saving the seals. It is 7:42. Where's the thing? What happened to my duck? I thought we had a duck back in here. See, we're supposed to just go right into this without a whole lot of goofing around, and somebody took my duck. Let's try that again. Now we lost a minute. It is 7:43. Duck, but it's going to have to do. Now from around the world, across the nation, and WRL, time for the Jerry St. James Hot Flash News of the Morning, brought to you this morning by the new Polish electric shoehorn. It works fine, except the friction sets your socks on fire. Because here we go. In the news this morning, 8 inches of snow fell on the Twin Cities yesterday and last night. And coupled with high winds and low temperatures, it is considered to be a pretty good storm. Plows were out all night clearing roads, and the storm is perhaps best described by one of the men who operated the plows all night to keep the roads open. He said, "I haven't seen such a snow job since Stenvig won the election." Well, that's what he said. Don't blame me. Ronald Reagan. Well, Ronald Reagan formally announced his candidacy for presidential primary elections yesterday in Florida, where he went to enter that state's primary and officially kick off his bid for the presidency. Some political observers think Reagan may give President Ford a run for his money. Others think not. Said one congressman in Washington yesterday, "I don't take Reagan seriously. In fact, as far as the presidency goes, I hear they've named a pizza parlor after his chances. Shakey's." One of the world's most sought-after beers for years has been Coors, the beer of the jet setters. Then a few months ago, the in beer came from Australia. That's called Foster Lager. Now the in thing to drink if you really want to show you know what's happening is a beer from China, believe it or not, called Yensing beer. It tastes fine, but it has one drawback, getting drunk on it. If you drink too much of this Chinese beer and get bombed, you have a wild desire to take everybody's clothes off and iron them. Well, you do. The administration released figures yesterday showing the cost of living was up in October by 0.7%. The unemployment figure is about the same, and people who do have a job are seeing that their money buys less and less of what it used to. It's really frustrating to go into a bank on payday to cash your check and have the teller say to you, "How do you want this, heads or tails?" For some time, hold it, you'll like this one. For some time, there's been speculation among social scientists about whether or not there still exists a tribe of cannibals deep in the jungles of darkest Africa. Well, apparently there are some cannibals left in the world. An expedition from the Smithsonian Institution, led by a group of distinguished scientists, report coming across a tribe of cannibals just last week. The head scientist in charge of the expedition says he knew they were cannibals when he came upon their village and heard a tribesman say to a friend, "I just can't stand my mother-in-law." To which the other native replied, "Forget about her. Just eat the noodles."
Right.
I like that one myself. Finally, in the news this morning, there's something to be said for complete trust in your wife or complete naivete. U100 sales manager Patrick signed on the dotted line Rickard and his wife were home last night watching television when the phone rang. Rickard answered it and said to the caller, "I don't know. You'll have to get that information from the Weather Bureau." When his wife asked him who called, he said, "Beats me. Some guy wanted to know if the coast was clear." Yeah! 7:49, 11 in front of 8 o'clock as you head off to work and school. This is Jerry Save the Seals, St. James. I want to thank you so much for joining us here on this Friday. Going to have a little bit of information about the Seals for you right after this very handsome and marvelously talented young gentleman tells you where he will be appearing this evening. Yes, here he comes.
Hello there, Jack.
Come into the garden.
It is 7:52, 8 minutes in front of 8 o'clock. We have had, over the past 4 days, requests for, are you ready for this, 10,000 petitions for the Seals. Can you dig that? All right, tell you what, we're not taking any more requests here, okay? So don't call the office anymore, because quite frankly, we are completely out of petitions. And if we took any more requests, you wouldn't get them for at least a week, okay? So we're going to get them all out there. That gives us room for 70,000 signatures. So all next week and for the next 2 weeks, we're going to be talking to you about getting those things all filled up to save those Seals. Okay.
Bye.
U100, that's Phoebe Save the Seals Wonder with St. James in the morning at 7:56. 4 minutes now in front of 8 o'clock. Hi, you. Hey, a number of people have called over the last week, and this is kind of interesting, so listen up for a second. They want to know a little bit more about the International Fund for Animal Welfare, and that's the group that we're going to send all the petitions to, you know. It's a kind of a worldwide organization, and it's a very good organization. Very briefly, let me just tell you what it does. It just does all kind of, it looks out for seals and any endangered species. The interesting thing about this particular organization is they don't rip you off. I mean, some charitable organizations take a dollar and 80% of it goes for administration. That's not true. 14% of every dollar goes to administration, and the other 86% goes to actually helping the animals. And they're very concerned with not only the seals. They have recently done a thing called a polar bear airlift, where a bunch of polar bears are going to be destroyed up north, and they tranquilize them all, put them on a plane, and ship them someplace else. They're very concerned. There are a lot of natives over in Africa that are slaughtering manatees, which are big animals that look like walruses. All right, they're taking care of that. They're taking care of sea otters. It's a wonderful organization. And the neat thing about it is they work on a project until they finish it. They never give up. That's their big thing. I tell you what. You can join this organization for next to nothing. If you'd like to join, I will give you their address here in about 10 minutes. So get a pencil, and I'll give you their address, and you can join them. Okay, and they send you information. You get a newsletter like every month, tells you what they're doing with pictures, and it's the best animal organization I've found, and I've been into animals here as long as I can possibly remember, and I belong to everything, and this is the best one going. So if you'd like more information, I'll give it to you in a little bit here. 7:57, 3 before 8 o'clock on a Friday with St. James in the morning.
Direct your pimples away. Fast.
On the St. James radio program, 21 chilly degrees outside. Be careful, the roads are bad. U100 WYOO AM/FM stereo, Richfield. It is 8:01. Good morning. I'm Jerry St. James, radio person extraordinaire and author of the best-selling book, 75 Erotic Things to Do with Cream of Wheat.
I don't believe it.
Oh! U100, that is Jigsaw, and it's called Sky High. It is 8:04, which means...
Yeah.
It means... What does it mean?
Hit the piano, will you, Artie?
Thank you. That's what it means. It means it is time once again for a look at television's worst sex and scandal-ridden soap opera, Search for Last Tuesday. Let me take a look at the TV guide here. Here it is, 3:30 today on Twin Cities Television. If you're at work, if you're at school, if you're out of the house shopping, here's what you'll miss on Search for Last Tuesday. Today, on Search for Last Tuesday, Marsha asks the question, if I order an extra blanket for my hotel room, will I have to pay a cover charge? Because a cover blanket. All right, I'll get you with this one, though. Meanwhile, the bridge to town is washed out, and Joanne has to take the ferry across the river, even though he doesn't really want to go across the river. Time I turn around, you're in here this morning.
Yeah, I know. I seem to live in here, I think.
I know. It's news time once again in these big towns.
News time again, yes.
Boy, I see people. Look at this. This is cruddy. I see people here going by the window, and they're all just sliding and spinning. Tires are just tooling out there.
Well, it's super bad out there. That's
Yeah. The main roads, I guess, like 35W, and they're probably okay by now, right?
Yeah, they should be.
But, see, look at this poor lady here. She's going bananas. That's it, dear. Go ahead. Just steer the left when you're going. Look at it. Hey, listen. Don't worry. Listen, after you hit your... After you overcome the shock of hitting your first pedestrian, the rest is all downhill. Be careful on the side roads, though. Even Cedar Avenue is bad in some spots. It's crummy outside. Stay home today. Invite me over. We'll have a cup of Campbell's soup and sit by the fire.
You're a nice dude.
Thank you so much. Well, what's happening?
Well, I suppose I should give a little wing here to the weather so people will know what they missed last night when they went to sleep early so they can get up early so they get to work. I'm Art Silver, Michael J. Douglas, and it's 20 degrees right now in the Twins. Minnesota's banded at the moment by a southwest to northeast blanket of snow in the wake of the first winter storm of the season. State residents and highway crews are beginning the massive shoveling out process to open areas virtually shut down by the heavy snows and the high winds of the day before. Driving conditions are hazardous today because of the icy roads and strong winds and blowing snow. All the winter storm warnings are gone now. However, you can look for a lot of windy weather throughout the day today, making driving just as hazardous. Maybe not quite as bad as it was last night, for sure, but pretty doggone hazardous, so watch yourself. There have been three deaths related to the storm so far. Granite Falls man died of a heart attack while putting on his snow tires, and two Twin City men also suffered heart attacks while they were shoveling snow. And at the moment, authorities are searching for an Ethan woman who disappeared yesterday afternoon while traveling from Minnesota to South Dakota in the middle of that blizzard. Officials say Joyce Ningbauer left Minnesota in a pickup truck yesterday afternoon. The stalled pickup was later found, but there was no sign of the Ethan woman. A Mitchell woman believed lost in the storm was found safe in a stalled passenger bus. Mrs. Bernard Lanners left Mitchell yesterday for Alexandria, but her vehicle was later found abandoned. She said that her car became stranded, and she made her way to a stalled bus because there was more room and it was warmer to sit in there. Ronald Reagan and his wife Nancy plan to fly to North Carolina and Illinois today, part of their two-day swing to announce his candidacy for the GOP presidential nomination. The federal hearing will be held in Miami today for the college dropout. That's Michael Carvin, who pointed a toy pistol yesterday at Ronald Reagan. Secret Service agents say the 20-year-old Carvin refused to make any statement after three agents wrestled him to the ground outside a Miami hotel. Lynette Frohm's lawyers won permission to question prosecutors about alleged brainwashing of a witness who says he heard Ms. Frohm's first remarks after allegedly pointing a gun at President Ford. Ms. Frohm yesterday made her first appearance in the courtroom in weeks. Federal Aviation Administration is investigating a report that four missiles or rockets flew past a West Palm Beach, Florida, to Washington Eastern Airlines flight south of Richmond. Officers aboard the DC-9 reported to the FAA Wednesday that they did see the missiles go zinging on by. The lighting industry has stopped a government safety program designed to find defective Christmas tree lights before consumers buy them this season. The Consumer Product Safety Commission program involved use of volunteers looking through store inventories, which must have really bothered just about everybody. Why not whey? Well, I'll tell you. The Foremost Food Company of San Francisco is studying a proposal to convert an estimated annual 13 billion pounds of whey. You know what whey is? That's the fluid byproduct of cheese making. Little Miss Muffet sat on her tuffet getting bombed on curds and whey. They're going to make the whey into booze. Initial tests conducted by Oregon State University indicate the plan might produce wine that is both inexpensive and tasty. A little cheesy, maybe. Curiously, the research is being supported by a $113,000 grant from the Environmental Protection Agency. The EPA is involved because of the disposal problems caused by all that whey. Representative Fortney Stark of California has termed the grant indulgence in a ridiculous project. Maybe it is. If you've ever wanted to win a real big one, a really, really big one from a one-armed bandit, you may as well forget it. Nevada gaming experts say having a $100,000 jackpot on a slot machine is a nice idea, but it wouldn't be fair to you, really, because the experts say that a $100,000 jackpot could only occur once every 48,000 years. And by the way, if you've ever wondered if it was right to spit on somebody anywhere in the world, it is if you're in Tanzania. It is proper to spit at somebody. The Maasai tribesmen of Tanzania will spit at each other to show respect and goodwill. Why don't you try that on your boss this morning? See how it works out. Oh, thank you. That's awfully nice of you. Get a handkerchief out of here. You want to save the seals weather, clear to partly sunny through tomorrow, local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. High today around 25, low tonight around 10, and now it's 20, and it's cloudy, and it's windy, and I'm Art Snow from Michael J. Douglas with Save the Seals, St. James.
That's good morning. Let me just stick my face in here very quickly. How'd you like to have Guido read your horoscope to you? Right now on the telephone, I'm taking calls from several of you very lucky listeners at 452-3333. Call in and ask for Guido. I'll do your horoscope and maybe have a little surprise for you this morning. How's that? Just call up and ask for Guido. My Lord, I really want to see you.
Saturday morning on the radio. I believe Guido is on a thing. Aren't you, Guido? Are you saving... No, you're on the telephone with someone with a horoscope at 8:15. Let's check in with the man himself here.
Well, good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Who's on the telephone this morning with Guido? Who's this?
Wendy.
Wendy, hi.
Good morning, Wendy. Hall, how are you?
Fine. How are you?
Wonderful. Oh, Guido's always fine, my dear. Wendy, let me...
Past 8 o'clock. Rex King is just a couple minutes away here. And coming up next, I'm going to give you the address for the International Fund of Animal Welfare if you want to join them. All right? So get a pencil ready. 100 where Rex King is next. It's a couple minutes past 8, 20 after actually is really what it is. 20 past 8 o'clock. As you head out to work or school this morning, give you the address for the International Fund for Animal Welfare here. A lot of people have been calling and saying, can I join? Yeah. They just asked for a small donation. There's no, like, membership fee or anything. You just send them a buck or more if you can afford it, because that's how they, you know, that's how they get their bread. But it's a very simple address. I'll give it to you. Very, very simple. Just send it to IFAW. That's International Fund for Animal Welfare. But just put IFAW, Post Office Box 9744, okay, 9744, Cleveland, that's in Ohio, and the zip code is 44140. That's IFAW, Post Office Box 9744, Cleveland, Ohio, and the zip code is 44104, and they will send you all the goodies, the newsletter by the seals, and just keep you up to date with what they're doing, all right?
Scotty's Ski Tips.
Use your Shopper's Charge or Bank AmeriCard. The famous watch sale on now through tomorrow only at all Sayers Shopper City stores.
Don't forget, tonight I'll be out live at the Cottage Grove Cheapskate out on Cottage Grove there with sealed petitions and goodies to give away. Come on out and say hi. We'd love to see your face, all right? Be out there from 7 o'clock on tonight. Here comes my favorite part. Ready? Let's have some la-la-la. For the la-la-las at the end. They should make a whole record like that. I don't know. I'm weird. I like it. It's 8:26. 26 past 8. That's the Save the Seals time on the St. James radio program this morning. And here he is, the world's only singing weatherman. A nice warm round of Twin Cities applause, please, as you head out to work this morning in a terrible traffic mess. I'm looking out the window right here now at, what is this, Cliff Road? And there's just a big backup at this light, and there's a tow truck out there. Really bad. Just really, oh, be careful, mister. Really bad out there. Anyway, let's hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, Rex King is here.
This is Rick King, world's only singing weatherman. Morning, Jerry St. James. Morning, Artie Snow. Morning, Michael J. Donuts, wherever you are. And morning this morning to all of my Rex King radio rangers this morning. I'm fixing to come in here and sing the U-100 Save the Seals weather from Minneapolis, St. Paul, the Twin Cities, and my dear all-American anti-communist hometown of... Fridley, Minnesota, garden spot of the Midwest. Yes, indeedy. I want to thank everybody for calling in here and ordering them petitions. We ain't taking no more orders for petitions because we's out of them. We sent out 10,000 of them already. So for the next 3 weeks, we're going to be telling you all about saving them seals and getting everybody to sign up on them petitions. All righty? God, I just love you. I want to thank you so much. All right, let me get on with it here. Let me get on with it. Also, before I get started, I want to thank y'all very much for sending in them cards and letters about Rex King, saying enjoy the program and everything. I want to tell you, please, whatever you do, keep them cards and letters coming in. Why? Because the station's running out of Sherman. That's why. We got clear, hold it, clear to partly sunny through to Maury. Oh, my goodness, it is so cold out there. I just cannot believe it. My wife last night, dumb woman, wanted to go out parking. Can you believe that? It is so romantic out there with all the snow. Why don't we go out parking? That dumb woman. She thinks we's back east again where it don't snow much. You got Lover's Lane out here anywheres? I like Lover's Lanes. My wife and I used to go all the time up to one there. Out there east in Poughkeepsie, we used to go up. I had a convertible, don't you know? We used to put the top down, go up there parking with all them young folks up there in Lover's Lane. There's cars all around us. We used to just kind of turn on the radio real low, don't you know, and sit there. One time I remember my wife and I, we sitting there parking, and she says, ain't this beautiful? Look at them stars, and the night air is so clean and clear, and just listen to all them crickets. I said, they ain't crickets, they're zippers, is what they are. Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. Wasn't too hazardous last night for me to get on out to one of them bars in Fridley. One of my good buddies was having a birthday party, so me and a whole bunch of the boys go over to the bar there.
Had about 3 cases of green belts and everything. We played a little foosball, some pinball, a little pool, some shuffleboard. Had a good old time. It was wonderful, I wanted to tell you. But you know what they had there? You ever seen an ice sculpture where they take a big block of ice, don't you know, and cut something out of it like a moose or something? They had an ice sculpture there for him in the shape of Raquel Welch. It was lovely. You don't believe me? Just look at my lips. They're still frostbitten. Look at that. Around 25 with a low tonight near 10 degrees. I got home last night about 1:45. My wife was so mad at me, she says to me, Rex King, all you ever think about is sex and booze. Don't you know what good clean fun is? I said, no, what good is it? Everybody be careful on the way to work this morning because the roads is just downright terrible. Let me get on out of here right now while I still can. 21 degrees. 21? Lord, it's cold. 21 degrees in the Twin Cities. 22 degrees in the suburbs. And 63 in Fridley. My wife is probably just like your wife, don't you know? Always trying to make me jealous. Your wife do that to you? Women's just like that. They always putting on airs and everything, trying to make you jealous and worry about losing them and everything. My wife is classic at that. Last night after dinner, she come in there. I was reading the paper, don't you know? Smoking a cigar. My wife come in there and she leans over and she says, oh, yeah? Well, what would you say if I told you I was sleeping with your best friend? I said, well, I'd say you're a lesbian.
St. James, good morning. It's 8:33, save the seals time here. That's 27 in front of 9 o'clock. You are going to be late for work this morning. There is nothing you can do about it. I'm sorry, I've decided you're going to be late. Sorry. The roads are really crummy. You just drove in, right? From where?
Richfield.
From Richfield. Is it bad? Did you take 35W? Is that okay? But there, and then did you take Cedar or what?
35 and then Cliff.
Is Cliff bad?
Hmm.
Oh, just cool it. Right. Marvel says just cool it and everything will be okay. Of course, Marvel got here by dog sled this morning, so she ain't worried.
Is that all I get?
I forgot, and I don't have the news fanfare in there. You want it?
Another fanfare?
No, I found it here. Wait a minute. Here. Feel better?
All right.
There you go.
You.
What's happening?
Just made my blood rush and things like that. Well, as a lot of people that are sitting in various lines all over the Twin Cities can attest to, the traffic is pretty bad, mainly because of roads. Are pretty bad in the Twin Cities. Most of the people were ready for the storm we had last night, mainly because there was a lot of advance warning about it. A lot of people went out and got their snow tires on and things like that, got their car all tested up. Everything was all set, but when you get 20 inches of snow in various portions of the state and 8 inches right here in the Twin Cities, it didn't do a whole lot of good to get your car ready because it was buried anyhow. Traffic was very badly snarled all day yesterday. In Minneapolis and St. Paul, all over the Twin City area, a whopping number of fender benders and 3 storm-related deaths occurred over the state of Minnesota. They're still searching for one woman, an Ethan woman, who disappeared yesterday afternoon traveling from Minnesota to South Dakota in the blizzard. They found her stalled pickup, but there was no sign of her, so they're still looking for her at this time. Hopefully, it's all over now. The storm will die out in the northeastern part of the state by late tonight. We should get a little more windy weather here in the Twin Cities, blowing some of this junk we got on the ground around, but for the most part, it will not melt away. It'll just be nice and clear and cold into tomorrow. Driving will stay rather hazardous until the highway crews can get everything done, so watch yourself if you're out there. If you don't have to be out there, why bother to be out there? It finally happened. We've told you about this contest before, the Kanawha City Bridge Contest, you know, where people want to get to blow up the bridge. Well, it's all over now. Housewife Barbara Oros has finally won the Charleston, West Virginia newspaper contest. She gets to blow up the Kanawha City Bridge, and she'll do it Sunday morning. Mayor John Hutchison pulled Mrs. Oros' entry out of a box. She moved to Charleston 6 months ago, and simply she wanted to blow up the obsolete bridge because, quote, it will be the most exciting thing I've done since moving to Charleston, unquote. Sunday's also her husband's birthday, and that's how they're going to celebrate the birthday. That's another biggie. Michael Carvin will be arraigned today on charges that he pointed what turned out to be a toy gun at Ronald Reagan yesterday in Miami. So far, he has not made any statement at all on why he did it. Reagan travels to North Carolina and Illinois today, his second day as a declared contender for the 1976 GOP presidential nomination. Elsewhere, Spokesman for the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission said radioactive emissions from Northern States Power Company's Prairie Island Nuclear Generating Plant did not violate any limits. In a report filed to the commission, NSP said emissions during a 13-week period ending August 10th would exceed design objects for the plant if they continued for 1 year. Spokesman for the commission, Bart Buckley, said the design objectives must be aimed for, but they may be exceeded temporarily. Buckley said there is no need for corrective action at the plant at this time, the plant near Red Wing. One side of the fancy new $2 bill, which has been resurrected for the bicentennial, will carry an exact duplication of the famous painting, The Sign of the Declaration of Independence, with a minor exception. Seems that six of the signers portrayed in the painting were omitted on the new bill because designers felt the picture was too cluttered. I must say something about a sign of the times. I don't know what. Police in Como, Italy, after secret investigations, sealed off and uprooted 3,000 marijuana plants, which were being grown, believe it or not, all you farmers in Minnesota, for chicken feed. 65-year-old Celeste Maspero complained that the police had confiscated all his chicken feed. "They used to take my chicken feed." Said he'd been growing the pot plants for years. Then he threshed them out for the seeds and fed them to the chickens. Police say that Maspero apparently had never been aware that the seeds were considered desirable by anybody but the chickens, who couldn't stand them. As far as the weather goes in the Twin Cities, it's going to be a little better. Clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. High around 25, low tonight around 10. Right on stack traffic, it's 20 and cloudy and windy. I'm Mark Snow for Michael J. Douglas with Save the Seal, St. James.
Still a young steel baby. It is 8:42 now. That means, what does that mean? 18? In front of 9 o'clock on the radio with Jerry Save the Seal, St. James. 21 degrees. Coming up later, second prize on my show today is a two-piece kit to help fight inflation. It's a map to the nearest supermarket and a gun. U-100, that's the Jeff Starship here. Gracie Slick and Marty Ballin and Paul Cantor, all those bozos. Good record. I love it. Radio program this morning. It is Friday. It's our Friday edition of the Twin Cities Goes Off to Work show. Good morning. My name is Jerry Save the Seals, St. James. Nice to have you along here. I want to thank you on behalf of our entire cast and crew this morning for joining us, making this part of your Friday morning. Clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. Yes, it is. And it's not going up above 25 today, which means none of this stuff is going to melt. So it's going to be bad today on the roads. The main highways are clear, but you probably know that. I'm not telling you anything new if you're already out on them. But in case you have to go out today, things like 35W are pretty good, but secondary routes are kind of bad. So, you know, naturally, I know you hear this from everybody, but, you know, kind of take it easy, dear. Have some more stuff on the seals coming up for you later. A little information I'd like to share with you. All right? Okay, the official time here. Oh, we just did. Had the sound of the tone. Me, thank you, boys. 14 in front of 9 o'clock.
Charlotte.
Additional accompaniment by Jerry St. James. It is 8:48, 12 before 9. I got a little Todd Rundgren for you.
Leroy, boy.
U-100 on the way to work. Are you having a good time? Ha ha ha! No, I shouldn't make fun of you. That's not true. I'm just joking with you. Mendota Bridge is very bad. I just found out from Dick Martin's here. What else is bad?
Highway 110.
Highway 110 is bad.
Highway 13
is bad. That's it. Really bad, I'd say. But because people are going, oh, it's snowing. My God, I have to drive 3 miles an hour. And then somebody else drives 100 miles an hour, and there's a big pileup, and it's bad. But anyway, just hang in there. I'll be here till 10 o'clock, as always, and we'll get you there without any problem. Oh, tonight, all the roads will be clear. I've just decided. If you're not doing anything, it's a good night to come on out and have some roller skating fun. Well, there's no use me telling you about it when we have a professional trained announcer here who is coming into the studio at this very moment in time. As a matter of fact, we open the door, please, and bring this gentleman in here. We've gone to great expense to bring him here to tell you about this. Come on in, sir. All right, go right. Step up to the microphone and go right ahead. On the St. James radio program, it is 8:55 from U-100, your official Save the Seal station in the Twin Cities. 22 degrees outside, clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Blowing and drifting today, making driving conditions hazardous to watch your face. New from Barry Manilow. WYOO AM and FM stereo, Richfield. I'm here. Big doings this hour. It is 8:59, 1 minute in front of 9 o'clock. We got Rex King and Guido and the Hot Flash News and everything going on. So hang on.
We
the St. James radio program. It's about 3 minutes after 9 o'clock. Guido. Guido, you have something for us here this morning?
Good morning. Good morning. Oh. This is Guido. One
you got something?
Correct, Mr. St. James, as always.
Yeah.
I do have one or two things I would like to mention here this morning.
Real quick.
I'm with you. First of all, I had a call a couple of minutes ago from Julia Childlike, who said that she would not be in this morning. She can't get in because of the snow. And she would like us to use the time that she usually has on the radio every Friday to talk about the baby seals.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Secondly, I'm going to try my very best to sneak in another horoscope or two here before the day is over.
All right.
And thirdly, we're not taking any more calls for petitions
on the
breakfast buddies because we've got all that we can handle. We already have orders for 10,000 petitions to save them baby seals, and that's just absolutely wonderful. And Guido wants to thank you very much. We'll have them all mailed out to you within the next couple of days.
Yeah,
alrighty?
Yeah.
So in the meantime, stand by on the radio for Guido this
morning.
We'll
do it. We'll do it. 903.
Charlotte, bruising every life she touches.
Please.
From Paris to Saint-Tropez.
Oh, beat me, please.
Charlotte.
Not admitted.
See Charlotte, now showing at the Sky One Theater downtown Minneapolis, coming next Friday to the North Star Theater downtown St. Paul. Check your newspaper for showtime.
How's that for an opening? Is that better than a fanfare? Can you dig that? It's Guido's harp there.
I feel like I got lost in a Disney movie there.
No. How'd you like me to enlarge your perimeter of adult entertainment?
You do it, and I'll slap you down so hard you won't believe it.
Oh, dear. Well, I guess once again, by the look on your face and the...
Don't you touch me.
News copy in your hand. It's not what you said when you really want me. But it's news time, right?
Yes. Oh, yes, it is. Yes.
Your wife might be listening.
Yes.
My husband might be listening,
yes,
too.
Yes, that's true. He didn't mean it, Bruce.
No, what's happening?
No, let me see here. Authorities are hoping today's preliminary hearing, which is starting right this minute, will shed some light on why Michael Carvin would point a toy pistol at Republican presidential hopeful Ronald Reagan in Florida yesterday. Carvin has so far refused to make any statement. His bewildered brother and sister say his action must have been some kind of protest. Reagan today plans to continue the whirlwind campaign style he's conducted since announcing his presidential ambitions yesterday morning. He did that in Washington, then made stops in Florida and New Hampshire. Today he'll visit North Carolina and Illinois before he returns to California tonight sometime. Tight security measures will be in effect in Louisville, Kentucky today when the first annual National Democratic Issues Convention opens. 1,500 delegates and 8 men who want to be president on the Democratic side are expected to debate major national issues in 3 panel discussions. A federal court hearing has been scheduled for today, and the charges of blacks at South Boston High School have been brutalized and ridiculed, saying there's been no time to prepare an adequate defense. The Boston School Committee has asked for a 30-day postponement. According to a new Harris survey, Americans favor gradual decontrol of all domestically produced oil and natural gas over the next 3 years. 65% of those polled said they expect the price of gasoline to jump by 15 cents the first year price controls are lifted. The survey is based on a poll of more than 1,500 people. Sympathizing with the financial plight of New York City, the Tribal Council of the White Earth Indian Reservation here in Minnesota has passed a resolution offering a deal for Manhattan. The resolution says the Chippewa Band wants to expand its land base and enter negotiations with state and city officials in New York to buy back Manhattan Island on behalf of the American Indians. Well, they could certainly do worse. CBS News reports it has scheduled two one-hour television specials on the John Kennedy assassination for Tuesday and Wednesday night of next week. The programs, titled The American Assassins, will explore the question of whether Lee Harvey Oswald was the assassin and whether he was acting alone. The program, according to the network, will feature a showing of the home movie of the Dallas assassination filmed by Abraham Zapruder and will include a frame-by-frame computer analysis of the Zapruder film in an effort to pinpoint exactly when President Kennedy and Governor John Connally were struck by bullets. Congressman Michael Collin of Michigan said Ohio State fans are full of baloney. So he's betting 10 pounds of the stuff against an Ohio ham being wagered by Representative Mike Oxley of Ohio. The bet, of course, is for the Ohio State-Michigan game being played tomorrow. They had to do something for it. Conlon also claims that Ohio State legislature has passed a resolution declaring the phrase "Go Blue" to be an obscenity. He said the lawmaking body has instructed Ohio's Secretary of State not to reissue personalized license plates bearing those words to a Wolverine fan who just happens to live in Ohio. Take your Minnesota football and Big Ten football very seriously these days. U-100, save the SEALs weather, clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. By the way, next half hour I'll tell you how you can get tickets for the Vikings playoff games, if they indeed are in the playoff games. What was I saying? Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. The high should be around 25, the low tonight around 10. It's gone up a degree. It's now 21 and sunny. I'm Art Stoll for Michael J. Douglas with Jerry Save the SEALs, St. James.
With the song there that's been adopted as the theme song for zero population growth. Don't pull your love out on me, baby. All right, let's settle down in here. Try to act like adults for heaven's sake. It's 9-11. 11 past 9 o'clock. Listen, sometime this afternoon you're going to get that and just go bananas. What do we got here? Fooling around with 21 degrees outside. It's just a crazy Friday here. It's nice and snowy outside. If you're still in the car on the way to work, that's okay. We will get you there safely, I promise. Oh, yeah, coming up next right here on the radio, we got the hot flash news of the morning. I don't like that. U-100, it is 9:14. Now from around the world, across the nation, and up your alley, time for the Jerry St. James Hot Flash News of the Morning. Have you heard this yet? You have, okay. Brought to you this morning by the new Polish electric shoehorn. It works fine, except the friction sets your socks on fire. Well, it does. That's the friction part. All right, well, let's see what's happening here. In the news this morning, 8 inches of snow fell on the Twin Cities yesterday and last night, and coupled with high winds and low temperatures, it's considered to be a pretty good storm. Plows were out all night clearing the roads, and the storm is perhaps best described by one of the men who operated the plows all night to keep the roads open for this morning. He said, "I haven't seen such a snow job since Stenvig won the election." What he said. Best thing I can come up with. Don't look at me. He said it. Ronald Reagan formally announced his candidacy for the presidential primary elections yesterday in Florida, where he went to enter that state's primary and officially kick off his bid for the presidency. Some political observers think Reagan may give President Ford a run for his money. Others think not. Said one congressman in Washington yesterday, "I don't take Reagan too seriously. In fact, as far as the presidency goes, I hear they've named a pizza parlor after his chances. Shakey's."
Sure.
All they did. One. Hold it. Well, it's one of the world's most sought-after beers for years has been Coors, the beer of the jet setters. Then a few months ago, the end beer came from Australia. That was called Foster Lager. Now the thing to drink, if you really want to show you know what's happening, is a beer from China, believe it or not, called Yensing beer. It tastes fine, but it has one drawback. That is getting drunk on it. If you drink too much of this Chinese beer and get bombed, you have a wild desire to take off everybody's clothes and iron them. Take this Chinese one out of London. Well, let's try this one. The administration released figures yesterday showing the cost of living was up in October by 0.7%. The unemployment figure is about the same as always, and people who do have a job are seeing their money buy less and less of what it used to buy. It's really frustrating to go into a bank on payday to cash your check and have the teller say to you, "How do you want this, heads or tails?" Right. All right. Well, we'll try this one then. For some time, there's been speculation among social scientists about whether or not there exist tribes of cannibals deep in the jungles of darkest Africa. Well, apparently there are some cannibals left in the world. An expedition from the Smithsonian Institution, headed by a group of distinguished scientists, report coming across a tribe of cannibals just last week. The doctor in charge of the expedition says he knew they were cannibals when he came upon their village and heard a tribesman say to a friend, "I just can't stand my mother-in-law." To which the other native replied, "Forget about her. Just eat the noodles." Where's the bell? Oh, there it is. Finally in the news this morning, thank God, finally, there is something to be said for having complete trust in your wife or being a little bit naive. U-100 sales manager Patrick signed on the dotted line Rickard and his wife were home last night watching television when the phone rang. Rickard answered it and said to the caller, "I don't know. You'll have to get that information from the Weather Bureau." When his wife asked him who called, he said, "Gee, I don't know. Some guy wanted to know if the coast was clear." I see the boss pulling into the parking lot this morning. Be careful. Watch it. Oh, oh. 100. Good morning. I'm Jerry St. James. It's 21 past 9 o'clock. That's the official U-100 Save the SEALs time on the radio this morning here. I want to thank you so much. You know, so many people we can thank for calling in for petitions. A lot of very, very nice people have called in. So far, we are going to be sending out 10,000 petitions. We're not taking any more names because we don't have any more petitions, right? We'll have them all sent out to you by tonight. You should have them by tomorrow or Monday at the latest. And for the next 3 weeks, we're going to be putting on a big campaign to get all of those petitions signed. 70 signatures on each one, all right? U-100. 100 with a spinner's air. Falling in love with you, baby. It's 1972 gold there. It's 24 past 9, 9:24, St. Basile's time with St. James in the morning. Girls in the front office tell me we've had a number of people call up and ask for the address of the International Fund for Animal Welfare, so let me just very quickly give it to you again, okay? These are very good people. The IFAW is a worldwide organization, and they're just super. Briefly, they do take donations if you'd like to become a member. You don't have, they do ask you for one just to cover the cost of postage and stuff, and they ask you to send them, you know, if I were you, I'd send them at least a buck, okay? And make them a check. Don't send cash in the mail. The reason I'm even mentioning this is I've been working with the International Fund for Animal Welfare for a number of years now, and you know me, I'm a member of every animal organization in the world, right? And these people are just wonderful for two reasons. First of all, they're not a ripoff, okay? They will they ask you for a small donation, and only 14% of that is used for administrative costs. They send you a whole breakdown on it. They open up their books to you. They send you a little pamphlet on their expenses and so forth. Secondly, they work on a project until they get what they want. They will not give up, for instance, on this seal thing until the harp seal slaughter has been banned, okay? They do not give up on this. They have a 100% record. They also are concerned with animals worldwide. They work with preserving sea otters, okay, in Florida and places like that. Right now, there's a bunch of natives who are going about, well, I won't tell you how, but they're killing a bunch of manatees, which are they're very ugly animals. They look like walruses, sort of. They're really ugly, but they're wonderful anyway. Anyway, these natives are killing them over there in Africa, so the IFAW is getting on their case and stopping that, and they're just a wonderful organization. If you're really into animals and you want to find out what's happening with animals around the world and what you can do, and they very seldom ask for money, by the way. They just ask you to write letters or just be aware. You can just write to them. Drop a postcard in the mail, say, hey, send me some info, and they will. That doesn't even cost you anything. Post Office Box 9744, okay, Cleveland, 44140. Just send it to IFAW. You don't even have to spell it out. Post Office Box 9744, Cleveland, 44140. There are big offices in Canada, but there's a mail strike up there. You can't get any mail up there, so just send it to their Cleveland office, and they'll send you all the goodies. You might want to mention us if you want. You don't have to, but you might want it. And they'll send you all the goodies. They'll send you the whole seal story and pictures, and it's just a really super organization. Okay, enough of that. You send them a thing, and they'll send you the information back, okay?
Okay.
It's time to say. U 100 with Jerry Save the Seals St. James on a Friday, 21 chilly ones on the outside, and the official time at the sound of the tone this morning in front of Artie Snow. Me, thank you, Moose, and the news, 28 in front of 10. Well, here you are again.
Yes, here I am again.
Oh, last time around, I guess.
Yes, it is the last time around this morning.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. You have to do it tomorrow morning, too.
Oh, of course.
Both of us do. Well,
but yeah. Evidently, the storm is over, which
is
nice.
Yeah. Well, that's good. Well, what's happening?
It's sunny outside. Good morning. I'm Art Snow for Michael J. Douglas, 21 degrees, going up just a little bit in the Twin Cities. It'll be sunny most of the day today, you'll be happy to know. And that means that at least the roads will probably melt off, although the temperature won't get much above 25 degrees if it does get that high. So although it'll be good for skiing and snowmobiling over the entire weekend, because the stuff will stay on the ground, you'll be able to travel fairly well on the highways, which is good. I told you I was going to tell you how to get tickets. Well, I'll tell you as much as I can for you Minnesota Viking fans. The Vikes have announced the rules for a public ticket sale in the event that the National Football League Division and Conference Championship playoff games are held at Met Stadium. If the Vikings win the NFC Central Division and have one of the two best records in the NFC, a divisional playoff game will be held at either December 27th or the 28th. If the Vikings win the divisional playoff game and have the best record of the two remaining teams, the conference championship game will be held at Met Stadium January 4th. Specific dates for the divisional playoff and times for all the playoff games may not be known until a week before the playoffs. All Vikings season ticket holders have been sent their playoff invoices, which must be returned by December 8th. After season ticket holders have exercise their playoff option, the remaining tickets will be made available to the public, equally divided between mail order and over-the-counter sale. The ticket prices are the same as last year, $10 and $12 for the divisional playoffs and $12 and $15 for the conference championship. There is a limit of 4 tickets per person. Mail order requests for tickets will not be accepted with a postmark prior to December 1st, so there's no use sending for them right now. And over-the-counter sale will begin at 8 a.m. December 13th, and it will continue until all tickets are sold. Tickets will be available only at the Vikings ticket office. Got all that? First National City Bank lowered its prime lending rate to 7% today. The latest cut is a reflection of the Federal Reserve Bank's easier credit and monetary policies. The 0.25% reduction is effective on Monday. Most major banks are expected to make a similar reduction. And Reserve Mining Company has won at least a temporary victory in its fight with Federal Judge Lord from Minneapolis. A three-judge panel of the 8th Circuit Court of Appeals in Omaha, Nebraska yesterday ordered Judge Miles Lord to halt all further proceedings in the Reserve Mining Company case. The stay was ordered until the judges have decided whether Lord acted improperly by ordering Reserve to pay for an emergency water filtration system in Duluth. The appellate judges stressed that their order is in no sense a final one. They also ordered the Army Corps of Engineers to continue its filtration program in Duluth, and they told the Corps, the city, and state officials that they must bear in mind recent evidence showing that the program has serious shortcomings. Commenting on the judge's findings in Omaha, Judge Lord said their decision was a victory for Minnesota Governor Wendell Anderson. He called the appellate court order, quote, a victory for Governor Anderson, Reserve Mining, and the Duluth Chamber of Commerce, and a setback for the health of Duluth citizens. Reserve dumps 67,000 tons of taconite tailings daily into Lake Superior, and asbestos fibers found in the tailings and in Duluth's drinking water have been called hazardous to health. In fact, nobody along the North Shore was able to drink water yesterday. They were all requested not to because the storm whipped up the 15-foot waves on Superior and also whipped up all that residue of taconite tailings laying down there in the muck. A new program to rehabilitate heart patients was presented at a medical conference in Atlanta yesterday. Doctors say they're astounded with the results of this. The plan involves a diet that strictly controls the intake of all fat coupled with an exercise program. A significant factor in the program is that it actually reverses the hardening of the arteries through diet. U-100 Save a Seal's weather, clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing, drifting snow and stuff like that causing hazardous driving conditions today. So watch it until the highways look pretty clear. High today should be around 25. The low tonight around 10. It's 21 right now. Nice and sunny outside. And I'm Art Snow from Michael J. Douglas with Gerald St. G.
Good morning. This is
100. You're Save the Seal station at 943. It's 17 now in front of 10 o'clock. Cash face. Good. Oh, yes, indeed. One more time. Rex King, the world's only singing weatherman, on the radio and coming up next. St. James. Oh, you've blown it all sky high and it's getting totally out of hand. It is 9:55. Wrong. 9:45. Quarter to 10. Are you still in traffic this morning? Geez, I hope not. You're really late, aren't you? Hey, well, it's okay. On days like today, even bosses like ours say, Snow, I couldn't get in my own self, you know. That's all right. But tell you what we'll do. Why don't we explain to you why the weather is what it is? Could you welcome him, please? Yes, you will, I know, because you're the wonderful ones. Let's have it fair, yeah. Here he is, the world's only singing weatherman, Mr. Rex King, ladies and gentlemen. Hey!
Radio, but it's on the radio line. This year's Rex King, the world's oldest singing weatherman. Morning, Jerry St. James. I want to say morning to Artie Snow, and I want to say morning to all of my Rex King radio rangers this morning. Oh, yes, indeed, it does my heart good to see all these wonderful people working here this morning. We got all kinds of volunteers out here, and they're all working on them Save the Seals petitions. We're going to have them all mailed out to you. All mailed out to you tonight. You should get them by, tomorrow, Monday at the latest, all righty? And then we're going to work on getting them all signed for the next couple, 3 weeks. Alrighty. Good day. Let me take a look here. I'm fixing the duty. U-100 Save the Seals weather from Minneapolis, St. Paul, the Twin Cities, and my dear all-American anti-communist hometown of Fridley, Minnesota, the garden spot of the Midwest. That's where it is. By the way, before I get started here, I want to thank all my radio rangers for sending all them fan mail, cards, and letters. Don't you know, just saying how much they enjoy the Rex King Radio Rangers weather forecast. Well, thank you so much for sending that in. I want to send out a plea to you to keep them cards and letters coming in. Why? Because the station is running out of Charmin. That's why. Partly sunny through tomorrow in the Twin Cities, and it's gonna be colder than you know what. You'll freeze your buns off. I know you will. You know what my dumb old wife done last night? She wanted to go out parking because she thought the snow was so romantic, don't you know? Dumb old woman. Good Lord. I
Wait a minute. Do y'all have a Lover's Lane around here? I ain't found it yet. My wife and I used to go to Lover's Lane all the time when we was courting, don't you know, back east in Poughkeepsie. Yeah, we used to go up here with all them young kids, put the top down in the car, just kind of sit there, turn the radio on real low, don't you know, about 12:30 at night and everything. Just kind of sit there, look out over the city on this hillside. There wasn't much to see in Poughkeepsie. We sit there anyway, though. It was wonderful. I remember one time we sitting there on this Lover's Lane, my wife says to me, ain't this wonderful up here in the dark here, just sitting here? Ain't it lovely, all these other cars around us, everybody smooching and making out, don't you know? Ain't the sky clear and beautiful? Ain't the air fresh and sweet? And just listen to all them crickets there. I told her, I said, honey, they ain't crickets, they're zippers is what they are. Local blowing and a drifting snow, causing hazardous driving conditions today in the Twin Cities. I'm getting better on this thing, ain't it? Getting fancier and everything. Yeah, I did get out of the house last night. Everybody else snowed in, but I go to one of them bars in Fridley where I always go. I had to go there because one of my buddies was having a birthday last night. So we all go over there, about 25, 30 of us, and we was all in this bar, polished off about 12 cases of Grain Belt, play a little pool, some foosball, shuffleboard, and everything. We had a good old time here in that bar. You know what they had there? You ever seen an ice sculpture? You know what ice sculptures? They take a big block of ice, don't you know, and they cut something out of it like a moose or something, you know? It was wonderful. You know what they had there for this dude in the middle of the bar? They had an ice sculpture of Raquel Welch. It was wonderful, I tell you. You don't believe me? Just take a look here. My lips are still frostbitten. Hazardous driving today. Watch out or you wreck your car and bust your buns. High today around 25. My wife was all bummed out of me last night. I didn't get home till 1:45, and she was so mad at me. She says, Rex King, is all you think about sex and booze? Don't you know what good clean fun is? I said, no, what good is it? Near 10 degrees. Gee, we're going to freeze your buns off here. There's going to be frost on your pumpkins tomorrow morning when you wake up, little darlings, let me tell you. Let me get on out of here now. 21 degrees in the Twin Cities. 20 degrees in the suburbs and 65 in Fridley. my wife is just like your wife. Always trying to make me jealous. You know how women's do that all the time? Women's is always trying to make you, you think that you're about to lose them and everything, so she holds on to them and love them extra hard and everything, don't you know? My wife's always doing that. She's a classic at that, ain't she? Yeah, your wife probably does the same. Last night, my wife come into me, and she commenced to pulling that trick on me again. She come in there. I finished dinner, don't you know? I'm sitting there in my easy chair, and I had my socks off and my shoes off, and I'm reading the paper, smoking a cigar there, sipping on a Grain Belt. My wife come in there. She says to me, what would you say if I told you that I was sleeping with your best friend? I said to her, well, I'd say you're a lesbian. That's what I said. Why does it be so cold outside here this morning? 21 degrees. Wah, 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 wah.
You are a man.
That's Glenn Campbell there and a rhinestone cowboy at 9:53. 7 before 10, the U-100 saved the SEALs time.
Charlotte. Charlotte, cherishing her own decadence. Charlotte.
U-100 with the Beach Boys here. That is called 409. Da, 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 da. 3 minutes in front of 10 o'clock. Running a tad late here. Let's go.
Hello?
Only at all Sayers Shopper City stores.
That's it for me. I got to get out of here. Brother Bob be on the radio next with all kinds of goodies for you. Have a nice one. Don't kill yourself in the snow. Want to see you tonight? We'll be out at the Cottage Grove Cheapskate. Don't forget, at 7 until 11 o'clock, skating and giving away goodies and stuff. Also, I will have a whole boatload of Save the Seals petitions for you, okay? If you want to come out there and sign one. So, hope to see you out there tonight at the Cheapskate in Cottage Grove. We're going to all get crazy. You have a nice one. If you can't make it out there tonight, I'll see you tomorrow. Come on in here and say goodbye because we're really late here. Radio audience parading by the microphone. Hurry up, you guys.
Come on,
here with your brother Bob. Well, my car spent the night in a snowbank, but I spent the night at a blizzard party. I'll tell you about the sordid details within minutes at Super U. U-100-1005 with your brother Bob. Well, you know, the National Weather Service tells you to take a coffee can, stuff a junk in it, candles and everything, in case you get caught in a blizzard. One of the basic prerequisites for a Minnesota blizzard is an alcohol bottle full of peppermint schnapps. Remember that. Half note off there, but yeah. Otto Stravinsky, right? 10:08 at U100 St. Lucille's weather, clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Low to blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions, but you know that high today 25, low tonight 10. It's 21 at Super U with the Eagles. 10:12 with you, Brother Bob. Oh, well, now we're going to have... I got a Barry Manilow. Try to get the feeling again, LP, the one that has I Write the Songs on it. And also, this hour, I've got an Elton John Rock of the Westies LP for you. Super U100, stand by to win. Chicago weekend starting this afternoon at 3 o'clock with Pat McKay sitting in for Tucker Morgan. We're going to do it all weekend long and give away copies of Chicago's Greatest Hits LP, the one that just came out at Super U100. Here's a blast from it. Feeling stronger every day at Super U. Chicago. It's a little pre-taste of our Chicago weekend beginning this afternoon with Pat McKay at 3 o'clock. Simon & Garfunkel up next in stereo from Endless Summer. How about Endless Winter, U100?
It's time to save. Now to the
left. Rob Sherwood had the quote of the year last night when he said, "How could two men who are so young and so rich feel so much pain?" That about sums it up. The first time they've been together in about 5 years, Simon & Garfunkel, My Little Town. 10:23, Brother Bob and the lovely Olivia Newton-John.
Hello,
next.
Rubenstein.
And the same to the name. Ultra Feminine 2 Radiant Action Cream by Helena Rubinstein. If you recognize my voice, say I recommend it. But please, don't give my age away.
Agnes Moorehead.
He's been a top news anchor man for years. Last year, he won an Emmy.
Well, you can save the seals at 452-1560. We still have some petitions left. We need your signature. 452-1560. Brother Bob, I just love these slow and sexy songs. How about you? 10:32, I'd super you. With the Dreesy Brothers, we just got to get it on again like we used to. U100. 10:34, Brother Bob and the Bay City Rollers. Saturday night, the Bay City Rollers LP. Super U100 at 10:37 with the Bee Gees. Spending a little night on Broadway next at Super U.
A feast of flowers.
233-33 right now. If you call number 16, you win yourself an Elton John Rock of the Westies LP from Super U. U100 having a cool and crazy night on Broadway with the Bee Gees. 10:42 with your brother Bob. And the OJs get on that warm love train next. 2:33:33, you get it in, I'll get it on. Brother Bob at 10:45 with the OJs. Everybody up on that love train, yeah. New group participation kind of thing, don't you understand? 10:47, it's by you. Back at Evil Woman. Back to back with American Woman. All right now, 10:50 at Super U 100 with a Guess Who. Out of that American Woman, Guess Who. 10:55 at Super U 100 with your brother Bob and David Boy kind of snuggling up next to keep each other warm next.
This Thanksgiving.
Happy for some obscure place, I guess. Davis Seals weather, 10:56. Clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing and drifting. May cause derelict problems in our jails tonight. High today about 25 with a low tonight about 10. It's now 21 at Super U. From the Young Americans LP, David Bowie. Chief of Play at WYO AM/FM Stereo Richfield. 1101 with your brother Bob and the Spinners at Super U. Crying on me, like moss. Barry Manilow from his Trying to Get the Feeling Again LP at 11:03. I write the songs at Super U 100 with 100% music starting at noon. Song from a great album, Trying to Get the Feeling Again, Barry Manilow. You can win it this hour at Super U at 11:06. Brother Bob and Carol King next. Stay in the Steel Station, 11:11 with your brother Bob at Super U.
What's cooking around?
Boy, I like it. 11:18. With your brother Bob reminding you that any gay person in need of help can contact Gay Community Services. 871-3111. America on a horse with no name. The Chicago weekend with plays and giveaways all weekend long. Listen to win right here on Super U at 11:21. Bringing back Elton from the Tommy soundtrack. Pinball Wizard at Super U. U100 at 11:26. I'm about to play the most depressing song that a DJ can play. As a matter of fact, if you don't hear me coming back afterwards, you know that I got smart and got out of the business.
Funny, it's too much of anything. It's not good for you, baby. Just 4/7. I don't know about that.
Anything, in used cars? I see. How about insurance? All right, well, thank you. There's nothing else a DJ can do.
With winter snows coming
soon enough.
100. No, I'm not down on the business. I love working 6 days a week and never having a holiday off. 11:34 at Super U with Jigsaw, Sky High from U100. This weather, partly sunny through tomorrow with blowing and drifting snow still. High today 25, low tonight 10. 21 degrees at Super U100 with my favorite Teton song by the Eagles, Lion Eyes. 100, we're going to get crazy this weekend. We got a Chicago weekend with plays and giveaways of Chicago's greatest hit LP. Just came out, well, there's more than one hit. Just came out last week, and you're going to get a chance to win a copy this weekend. 100% music next hour, 11:45, with your brother Bob at 452-3333. You get it in, I'll get it on. Those Nash men, they were good, weren't they? Carry on, 11:50, at Super U 100, I'm on fire with 5,000 volts. It's Super U. 100% music, less than 8 minutes away.
Charlotte.
Leaving only scars. Charlotte. Cherishing her own decadence. Charlotte. Bruising every life she touches. From Paris to Saint-Tropez.
Right.
Charlotte. A film by Roger Vadim. With music by Mike Oldfield. Charlotte. A motion picture that enlarges the perimeters of adult entertainment. Liz Smith of Cosmopolitan magazine calls Charlotte a charming and chilling movie that is guaranteed to open both your eyes and mouth in shocked disbelief. This film isn't for the faint-hearted, nor those given to blushing. Charlotte, a Gamma 3 release. Rated X, under 17, not admitted.
See Charlotte, now showing at the Skyway 1 Theater downtown Minneapolis, coming next Friday to the North Star Theater downtown St. Paul. Check your newspaper for showtime.
This Thanksgiving, the holiday of American tradition, remember the warmest, most beautiful, and brightest
of all things.
They have changed the letters and the words to the song. They drink a little beer, smoke a little doobie, fall down tonight. with Brother Bob, bringing back regurgitating the Beatles for you. It's Super You.
Time to say.
100 WIOO AMFM Stereo, Richfield, 1203, with Brother Bob and Silver Convention. Fly, Robin, fly. It's Super You. 1206, Brother Bob. This is for my little sugar bear, Mona. Nobody else can say it better than Chicago. It's Super You. That song gives me goosebumps. Just listen to the words. Only the beginning. Chicago, it's Super You. 1213 with your Brother Bob off on a cruise with John Zamper, Calypso, from the Windsong LP. U100. U100, John Zamper. 1216 with your Brother Bob at 3 Dog Night.
U100?
With 100% music this hour, your Brother Bob's got Elton John, the Island Girl, from Super You. Down the river on that riverboat, just rolling and a bowling at Super You. Seals weather, 1226, clear to partly cloudy through tomorrow, with blowing and drifting snow still making driving a little bit of a bummer, man. High today about 25, low tonight 10. 21 degrees at Super U100. Go dance with me in Orleans. With a severe attack of those feelings at Super U. Chicago weekend looming upon us at 3 o'clock this afternoon. This is Chili Dog Day at Super U. This is the day that stock in Northern Natural Gas goes down about 15 points due to oversupply. 36 at Brother Bob at 452-3333. Or you can instant rip me for an Elton John Rock of the Westies LP if you call number 27. It's Super U. It's my man, Charlie Daniels. Charlie Daniels, Birmingham Blues, from his Knight Rider LP. 1239 at Super U in the Chicago weekend, starting at 3 this afternoon. Plays and giveaways of Chicago's greatest hits LP all weekend long at Super U. Well, Genesee did it back in the late 1960s, and then Stories did it in the 1970s. A touching story of interracial love. Brother Lou at Super U. U100, the station that says, if you can't go to Chicago, we'll bring Chicago to you this weekend with plays and giveaways of Chicago's greatest hits at Super U100. U100 with the lovely, at least he has some talent, Olivia Newton-John. The touching song, He Ain't Heavy, He's My Producer.
He's my brother.
John from a Clearly Love LP. You know, I don't mean to put Olivia down. Anybody that has developed the art of vamping across the stage like she has clearly deserves a break, huh? Jefferson Starship at Super U. Oh, 56, Brother Bob, I don't mean to be so sarcastic today, but if you lived through what I've lived through in the past 24 hours, your attitude on life would be a little changed too, man. While we're on this subject, let's spill some wine with Eric Burden and more. WIOO, AMFM Stereo, Richfield. 101 with your Brother Bob and KC and the Sunshine Band. That's the way I like it. A little lower. A little softer. Yeah. For Chuck and Morgan at 2 this afternoon, he's going to start off the Chicago weekend at 3 with plays and giveaways of Chicago's greatest hits all weekend long. And Super U 100. Save the Seals weather, high today 25, low tonight 10. It's going to be sunny right on through this evening. No more snow. Oh, I'm just getting used to it, too. Beatles, it's Super U.
Hey,
14 with Brother Bob at Super U, reminding you that anyone suffering from drug addiction can get help from Drug Abuse Services Project. 333-2335, Jigsaw, Sky High. Huh? 17, getting real tacky this afternoon with Pat McKay at 2 o'clock. Know what I mean? Regretfully announces the Bay City Roller. Oh, let's pop and rock and roll. 123 at Super U United with Sweet from the Desolation Boulevard LP. U100 presents our first second annual turkey trot. We had one last year. Oh, what a blowout that was. This is going to be next weekend, 8 p.m., St. Paul Civic Center, Frank Zappa and the Mothers from Super U. U100, yes. 31 with Brother Bob, we're having a rock and roll party this afternoon. It's going to give it crazier in a half an hour with Pat McKay and 100% Music. Hits you by you. B100, well, just a little while ago, he played Sweet Ballroom Blitz. And a lot of people called him and said, hey, man, dump that turkey and go for the new one. It's out of sight. So here it is. This is from the Desolation Boulevard LP. It's Fox on the Run. Sweet, it's Soup by You. Fox on the Run. Oh, I got plenty of them, baby. You want a couple? B100, where Pat McKay counts down this week's top 15 songs this afternoon at 4 p.m. Listen and win them on Soup by You. U100, 140, Brother Bob, it's two for you. I know I shouldn't have gone down Hennepin Avenue last night. I peeked into one of the windows, you know, of those kind of funny places. My wild thing got out of control and killed 14 people. 100, 143, Brother Bob, play my favorite new song by Electric Light Orchestra, Evil Woman. Brother Bob, boy, do I feel raunchy today. It's a shame I had to leave the party to come to work. Back right afterwards. Hey now. Elton John from the soundtrack of Tommy, you all. The Pinball Wizard, it's Soup by You. In response to a request that just poured in a moment ago, Paul McCartney and Wings, the Venus and Mars, and a rock show for your musical pleasure at Super U 151 with Brother Bob standing by for Pat McKay to start off a Chicago weekend at 3. The plays and giveaways of Chicago's greatest hits LPs all weekend long. 100, 157, that's about it for Brother Bob. I'm going to leave you with a taste of Pretzel Logic at Super U, and then Pat McKay's going to come on next. At 3 o'clock, he starts our Chicago weekend with plays and giveaways of Chicago's greatest hit selfie. It's brand new, and it's just out of sight. Super U.
U100 WYOO, AM/FM Stereo Richfield, 2 p.m., the boyish charm of Pat McKay. Hundred say of the seals weather, clear to partly cloudy and sunny through tomorrow. That doesn't make sense, but that's what it says. Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. High today around 25, a low tonight near 10. Right now, the city is cloudy and windy at 21, right on Super U. McKinney afternoon, working on 20 minutes of non-stop rock and roll. The second annual Turkey Trot is Wednesday, 8 p.m. at the St. Paul Civic Center with Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention from U100, the station with the concerts. Here's America.
That's right. Yeah.
What the hell, who cares? Numbers 8 and 9 at 452-3333. Get me on the instant rip as close as your telephone. Rock and roll, so leave us right on Super U.
for you at Pat McCann 217. When I say I'm going to play Elton John, I play what I say. From 452-3333 and another instant rip-off winner. This is the Tiny Dancer and a Blue Jean Baby right on the Super U.
Blue Jean Baby.
Let's check him out right now and see who's on there. Hi.
Hey.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello. U100 Pat McKay Silver Convention, Fly Robin Fly at 225 Minneapolis, St. Paul. A true musical masterpiece.
Charlotte. Act of love. Charlotte. Taking every pleasure, leaving only scars.
You got it.
Charlotte. Cherishing her own decadence. Charlotte. Bruising every life she touches, from Paris to Saint-Tropez.
Cold shower time.
Charlotte.
And shells of flannel and woven plaid shirts. Life just wouldn't be the same without Levi's. And Levi's just wouldn't be the same without the Midwest Trouser Exchange. With Sal Court, Southdale, Ridgedale, Brookdale, and Rosedale.
Super U, I'm Pat McKay at 227 this afternoon between 4 and 5 o'clock. I will count down the top 15 songs in the Twin Cities and give you a chance to win them all. Plus, starting at 5 o'clock, a Chicago weekend. Here's Barry Manilow, right on Super U.
I've been like...
U100 Pat McKay here at 231 Minneapolis, St. Paul, on North America's number one boogie station. Harry Chapin, the cat is in the cradle, and the baby's outside with a catnip.
A child arrives on from the don't know when, but we'll get together then.
New or slightly used toy at any Twin Cities 7-Eleven store. Do your part for the U100 Toys for Tots campaign. I'm Pat McKay at 234. How you doing, man?
One love guy.
Thank you.
sky high. Stand by for Steely Dan next off my request line at 452-3333, where you can call me right now.
Leg. Any skier will ski better and more comfortably with a modern ski boot.
Stop by the Lift Ski Shop for the latest advice on what the ski world is all about. The Lift on Highway 65, 1 mile north of Highway 694 in Fridley.
Super U, where you can hear the BBC Rolling Stones concert special. That's Sunday night at 10 p.m. Pat McKay here at 2:40. And Steely Dan, the Countdown to Ecstasy LP. And Ricky,
don't lose that stash.
We had a...
Ricky, don't lose that number. You want Hunter of Pat McKay at 244. We let Jeff Mother Robbins out of his cage tonight at 9, and he counts down the top 15 most requested oldies on the Acapulco 15. It gives you a chance to score, babe. The streets and save the seals. Weather does not look that bad for the weekend. Clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. High today around 25. What do I mean that doesn't look bad? Low tonight near 10. Right now, a cloudy sky and 31 in the Twin Cities with the Beach Boys and I love them California honeys. Beach Boys, California Girls. Answering the musical question, is there any difference between California and Minnesota girls? Only during the winter, because when they take their clothes off, Minnesota girls don't have the right tan marks. Mr. Glenn Campbell. Little rhinestone cowboy. Glenn's definitely the kind of guy you like to bring home to mom. Huh? Stand by for the Eagles next, right on Super U.
Tom Harrison is the new TV.
You want Hunter at WIOM-FM Stereo Richfield. I'm Pat McKay. How would you like yourself a Barry Manilow? I write the songs of them. You got it. They're in concert this coming Wednesday night at 8 from Shone. And U100, the station with the concerts.
Thank you.
Yes, I'd like to remind you that any gay person in need of help can I gotta do this straight. Can contact Gay Community Services at 871-3111. I promise I won't say anything else. Here's Carl Carlton. Ready to roll with Elton John. You won 100 Panda Candy afternoon, 311, working on 20 minutes nonstop, and Seven Wolf, Boulderize My Body, Baby. Somebody's on my phone. Hi, what do you want?
Play My Little Town for me.
My Little Town, ho, oh, dub, 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 dub. My Little Town is next, right on Super U.
You and me.
Save on famous Benrus LED quartz watches, the digital model. It's regularly $79.88, but through tomorrow only, it's just $69.88. Push the button for hour, minute, seconds, and date, and use your shopper's charge or Bank AmeriCard. The famous watch sale, on now, through tomorrow only, at all Sayers Shopper City stores. Super U and Pat McKay at 316 getting on that request for Simon and Garfunkel, My Little Town, and reminding you I've got a great cause. You can drop off any new or slightly used toy at any Twin Cities 7-Eleven store. Help out the U100 Toys for Tots campaign along with the U.S. Marines. Is the Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention Isn't Enough. Next Wednesday night at 8, we're bringing you Foghats, Montrose, and the group you're hearing right now, Black Oak, Arkansas. December 6th, St. Paul Civic Center, 7 p.m. This is by request from the X-Rated LP at 452-3333. Strong Enough to Be Gentle in stereo right on the Super U.
You look at me.
Oh my God, let me start over again, really. This afternoon, between 4 and 5 o'clock, I'll count down the top 15 songs in the Twin Cities, and at 5, the start of a Chicago weekend right on Super U.
Yeah.
Pimples at 325.
Super hit, the Pacific.
And it keeps on fighting pimples for 8 hours, invisibly. So nobody will ever know. Try Striden.
Super you and Time Can 327. I just gave away a Sweet Desolation Boulevard album to some chick from Minneapolis. I can't even remember her name. The state of the field's weather, clear to partly cloudy and sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing and drifting snow. High today 25, low tonight 10. Right now, 26 and cloudy in Twin Towns. This afternoon at 5, the start of a Chicago weekend with plays and giveaways of Chicago's greatest hits. You won 100 Happy Candy afternoon in Chicago for the start of the Chicago weekend this afternoon at 5. That's all days. 3:35, Minneapolis, St. Paul. Stand by for the Bay City Rollers next, right on Super U.
Midland Records is the record store with you in mind, with special prices like this every day. You'll find Midland Records behind the big yellow back door at the Maplewood Mall. And coming in March, you'll find Midland Records on the upper level of the new Eden Prairie Shopping Center. Midland Records. Records, tapes, all your music needs. And now, Midland also has tickets for all the great Stone concerts. Midland Records, the upper level record store in the Maplewood Mall.
Super U, I'm Happy K at 341. Now's the time to get on my telephone line. I'll take number 9, 452-3333. The longer you listen, the more you win.
Come on, 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 come on
on this. Song number 14 on this week's Top 15, David Bowie and Fame, right on Super U. U-107, song number 13, Eagles Lion Eyes and Sailor Seals Weather. High today around 25, low tonight near 10. Clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing and drifting snow. Right now 24 and fair right on Super U. U-104-13, I'm Pat McKinney afternoon, counting down the Twin Cities Top 15 records. So this song is number 12. The sweet.
Ready, see?
U-100 Panic Can 415, sign number 12 in the Top 15 Countdown, the Squeaks and the Ballroom Blitz. I want to know how in the hell I got there. Stand by for sign number 11 next, right on Super U.
During their pre-holiday Elton John Superstar Sale, going on from November 23rd through November 26th.
For you, I'm Pat McKay at 417. Four Loud Rock of the Westies, Elton John LP, and a chance to win an autograph for Rock of the Westies. Call me right now, and you be number 9, 452-3333. Song number 11, Top 15. ABBA.
When you're tired, carry me on.
$9.88. Push the button for hour, minute, seconds, and date and use your Shopper's Charge or Bank AmeriCard. The famous watch sale on now through tomorrow only at all Sayers Shopper City stores. Super U and Pat McKay just basically getting down at 426. Sign number 10, KC to Sunshine Band. In the top 15 countdown, this is song number 9, Jigsaw in Sky High. Right on, Super U. Any brand new or slightly used toy at any Twin Cities 7-Eleven store. Do your part for the U-100 U.S. Marine Toy Corps Toys for Tots campaign. 429, song number 8, Morris Albert, and the song is called... U-100 431, I'm Pat McKay. You can hear the BBC Rolling Stones concert special Sunday night, 10 p.m. right on Super U. Song number 7. U-100, Pat McKinney, afternoon, Simon and Garfunkel. Nothing but the dead and dying back in my little town, 434. That is song number 7 in the top 15 countdown this week in the Twin Cities. You be calling me right now at 452-3333. The top 3 songs are. If you get them all right, you get all 15 right on Super U with a long list.
There's a whole new way to find pimples. It's called MUDD. M-U-D-D.
I know how to spell it.
MUDD.
U-100 Pat McKay. BG's song number 6. Tonight's on Broadway. Song number 3. No, song number 5, I guess, is next. And, yeah, let me see. 6-5-4, yeah. Sign number 5 is next at 440, right on Super U.
Cooking around.
You'll find Midland Records behind the big yellow back door at the Maplewood Mall. And coming in March, you'll find Midland Records on the upper level of the new Eden Prairie Shopping Center. Midland Records. Records, tapes, all your music needs. And now Midland also has tickets for all the great Shawn concerts. Midland Records, the upper level record store in the Maplewood Mall.
Super U, sail the seals weather. High today around 25. Low tonight near 10. Blowing and drifting snow right down to Twin Cities. A cloudy sky, 24. Neil Sedaka and Elton John. This is song number 5. You on 100 Pat McKay and Neil Sedaka. That is Bad Blood, song number 5, along with Elton John at 445. And this is song number 4, Bay City Rollers. You won 100 Pat McKay Bay City Rollers. Sign number 4 is Saturday night. I'll have a winner on the top 3 in just a minute right on Super U.
Head on. Hey, Cap.
McKay 453, song number 2, you guessed it, Island Girl, Elton John. You won 100 Pat McKay, Elton John, Rock of the West is LP, and song number 2 is 455, song number 1 and John Denver is next. You won 100 WYOOAMFM, Stereo Whitfield, 502, I'm Pat McKay. This is the start of a Chicago weekend with plays and giveaways of their greatest hits LP all weekend long, right on Super U. U 100-504, Pat McKay, Rob Sherwood at 6 tonight. Save the city. Fields weather, clear to partly cloudy and sunny through tomorrow. High today around 25. Yes, again, Jack. Low tonight near 10. Right now, Minneapolis, St. Paul, a cloudy sky. 23. In my request, 452-3333. Deep purple and hush. Right on, Super U.
Quartz watches, the digital model. It's regularly $79.88, but through tomorrow only, it's just $69.88. Push the button for hour, minute, seconds, and date, and use your shopper's charge or Bank AmeriCard. The famous watch sale, on now, through tomorrow only, at all Sayers Shopper City stores.
Super U, Happy Cat 524, just basically getting down on a Friday night, the beginning of a Chicago weekend. 352-3333 is my phone number. Get out of right now. Free and all right now. Right on Super U. You want 100 Pat 29 Pat McKay. Summer sailor steals weather. Clear to partly sunny through tomorrow. Local blowing and drifting snow causing hazardous driving conditions today. Low tonight near 10. Right out of Twin Cities, a cloudy sky at 23. Jeff Mother Robbins counts down the Twin Cities top 15 most requested oldies tonight at 9 and gives you a chance to win them all on the Acapulco Gold 15, 528, and the Doobie Brothers. Pat McKay, 531, Robbie Baby Wonder Buns at 6 tonight, Elton John now. This is the Island Girl. Pat McKay, 534, the rock of the West East LP, Elton John. Stand by for Simon and Garfunkel next and Robert Sherwood tonight at 6.
Ralph. Right.
The key to this whole directory assistance problem here at Northwestern Bell is to get people to use the phone book.
Yes, sir. If people just realize that the cost of directory assistance is really reflected in their phone bills, I'm
what
sure
if we they... told folks that phone books make fascinating reading?
Simon and Garfunkel, My Little Towel, the second annual circuit trot featuring Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention in concert this coming Wednesday night at 8 p.m. from Shone, the new 100, the station with the concerts.
Poet. Drawing. Pulling.
Mud. Mud. Mud helps open up your pores.
Oils and gunk that cause pimples get a chance to get out before your skin breaks out.
Mud.
Super U, I'm Happy Can't Buy
the rip right now. I'm taking caller number 9-452-3333 and Bad Company from 1974 with Loving God Bad and Chicken Rock and Roll.
Baby, cause I'm a man, I got my pride. I don't need no woman to hurt me inside. I need a love like any other.
There's a new News 9 on KMSP TV. Have you noticed? Watch it at 5 and 10 o'clock.
Superhero, that's it, that's all. That's the general ticket for Pat McKay at night. Rob Slewood is next at 6 with more music on a Chicago weekend. I'll see you tomorrow afternoon at 1. I want you to keep loving.
Watch my clothes. I don't want you. Keep a hold.
Okay, 611, I got a Chicago sign by request. Just moments away, 452-3333, pair of tickets to you with 100 Frank Zappa and Turkey Trot. You got to get your tickets this weekend. Don't forget now, the U.S. Marine Corps and U-100 put together the Toys for Tots campaign this year. Give the kids who need it most something to celebrate their Christmas. Then drop your toys at the Twin City 7-Eleven stores.
Gentleness and dream. It says what you have no words for.
You can say what's meant with heaven's death.
This Christmas, haven't I?
$3 cover and drinks are only 10 and 20 cents. Yes, the Crystal Mist has it all for you. Great music, great drinks, and always a great time. Don't forget, everyone is getting off to everyday people all week at the Crystal Mist. Head over to the Crystal Mist on the corner of Frost and English in St. Paul.
Somebody on the line, guess what? Right. You won.
My win?
The newest. 627, I'm Rob Sherwood.
This is Nilsson.
Hunter Turkey Trot tickets coming up sometime this hour. I'm Rob Sherwood, Friday night, Chicago weekend. Here comes Mary Niels Tadaka. Bad blood. 100 Hungry Ears LP. I'm Rob Sherwood. Non-stop tonight and
get on.
A little Fleetwood back. It's called Fleetwood Mac, and the song is called Over My Head. Hey, young Americans, David Bowie's a couple of moments ago. Somebody wants to hear Silver Convention. Look out for John Denver. My request is
Midland Records.
You 100,
I'm our show at 643. Call me one. Somebody called me out a couple of moments ago for me. I want to remind all our listeners that Betty Crocker's in a hospital and you burned her bun. That's brilliant. Turkey truck pair. If you call me right now, 452-3333, Tracy Frank Zappa from Super U.
Thank you.
first one.
What?
You are the winner.
All right.
I recognize that voice.
What is it?
It's one of the number one all-time regular winners on Super U from Richfield Senior High School, the one and only McDonald's man, Michael Butler.
All right.
The longer you listen, the more he wins. You are the your instant dedication. You just gotta get it in before I can get it on. Electric Light Orchestra, second to one, right on. Super U. Yeah, oh, what a great song. It's called Evil Woman. I love that. It's 6:55 on Super U. 100 WYOOM FM 7 Richfield. 7 p.m. Time and girls. Rock of the West is 7:03. Twin Cities, I'm Rob Show, and then non-stop music tonight with Jeff the Mother Robbins.
News here. Everybody's going to want to hear. We're having a party. Yeah, it's Friday night. It's coming Friday. The Cheapskate Roller Rink in Cottage Grove has got a special night. That's this Friday night from 7 to 11 o'clock at the Cheapskate Roller Rink in Cottage Grove. I'm going to be out there.
I do.
Well, it's true. I am. Yeah. I want to see all of my breakfast buddies out there. We're going to have prizes and just everybody. In Cottage Grove this Friday night. All right? Yes, it's wonderful. You love it.
Did you know there's an acne medicine? Sardex medicated pads. Sardex.
You want 100 and save the well. Low tonight, 10 high tomorrow, 25. I think it's going to be all right. A little wind may blow a little bit, cause a little trouble. Going to melt off a little bit tomorrow morning. I like this. Winter time is here, and this is what it's all about. Minnesota. Get down. I want it.
Super hit. The Pacific.
In order to stimulate your memory and kind of jam your brain waves just a little bit tonight, the question is, what are you going to ask? If an egg and a half costs a cent and a half, how many eggs can you buy for a nickel? Where Jeff Mother Robbins cuts down the Twin Cities top 15 most requested old days, they are gold. They are gold. John, Mary and Hill Murray wanted me to play a romantic song for you. You won 100, and tonight Jeff Mother Robbins at the top 15 all come through to the most requested Super Bowl songs all week long at 452-3333. The Tricky Trot is next Wednesday tonight. I'll have tickets before 9 for you to see Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention. Right on. You won Memorial. Next time I play Desolation Boulevard, I'm going to give it away. Hey! You 100. You better get ready for sweet. Sometimes signal the call when you hear the song and call me. Get it in, get it out of 452-3333. This is Hamlin, SOS. You 100, Jeff Mother Robbins, Count Sadly, Alka, Vocal Gold. The number, try that when you're high. Tonight, run on for you. This hour, by request, a little bit of who? Sweet. And MC Riff, the Super U. The Who is taking away Super U. You want 100 WYOOAM and FM stereo, Richfield. Hey! 8 p.m. Give the kids who need the most something to celebrate this Christmas. You want 100 Toys for Tots campaign. Start of the Christmas season by dropping your toys in at the 7-Eleven store. Chicago Week. Hunter, Simon, and Guy Poole, stand by for the blitz. 33-33, it's the rip of the Chicago Weekend. All-time Frank Zappa tickets, Chicago's greatest hits, brand new album, the giveaway. Oh, yeah! Sometimes I just feel like Pompero Furpo. Wait a minute. I don't know, what was I going to tell you? Something exciting is really going to happen in a second. Look at it. Moments away.
a rocking school on Saturday night, dancing to the rhythm in our heart and soul on Saturday night. Aye, 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 I just can't wait. Aye, 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 I got a date. And the good old walking Lord, I'm going to show a tiger on
album Black Hook Arkansas and Crew. Excited by the wings for a huge concert from U100 December 6th. This is for you.
Let's
Chicago weekend. This is an hour of 100% music. Chicago. It's 9 p.m. And I am Jeff Mother Robbins. With Chicago's greatest hits albums I'm going to give away. Snap concert tickets to give away. And the Acapulco 15 countdown. These are the top 15 most requested oldies of the entire week. Buy your telephone votes at 452-3333. I'm counting them down from 15 to number 1. Your chance to win them all minutes away. The Who from Who's Next at number 15. Won't get fooled again. Sorry, I missed the post on that, so we'll make up for it, man. Same as Bill's weather, clear to partly sunny. Blowing and drifting snow continues, low about 10, man. High 25, 909. Jeff Mother Robbins here, Acapulco 15. Simon and Garfunkel, Mrs. Robinson. You won 100. 912 high, it's Jeff Mother Robbins, countdown the Acapulco 15 with your chance to win every album that all the Acapulco 15 gold songs are on at 452-3333. Guess the top three in correct order, and you will win them all. Jeff Mother Robbins at 452-3333. Counting down the Acapulco 15. I was holding down at 13. Crocodile Rock. And I got my Beats Baby. The wind in your hair. The sun in your face. And the sand in your teeth. D100. Counting down the Acapulco 15. That is first class. And Beats Baby at number 12. Jeff Mother Robbins here at 920. The Who won't get fooled again. 14, Simon and Garfunkel, Mrs. Robinson. 13, Elton, Crocodile Rock. 12, Beats Baby. Number 11, Elton John, Rocket Man. Number 10, Frankenstein, Edgar Wintergroup. Number 9, Elton Bitches Back. Smoke Out of Water, Deep Purple. Number 8. Turkey Trot with Zappa and the Mothers in concert next Wednesday night at 8. You can still get your tickets, man. Elton John again, number 7. U-109-41, Jeff Mother Robbins here on a Chicago weekend, which means there's more shipload of Chicago's greatest hits albums we're going to give away all night long, all day tomorrow, and all day Sunday. You just keep it right here and listen to win right on Super U. This Lynyrd Skynyrd, the first time out of the top 5. And Freebird at number 6. Off any brand new or slightly used toy at all the Twin Cities 7-Eleven stores. Well, not all at once, any one at a time. And do your part for the U-100 U.S. Marine Corps Toys for Tots campaign, 949. Elton John, Benny, getting down and honking them jets. U-100, Jeff Mother Robbins, 952, with the Acapulco 15 countdown. Elton John again at number 5 with Benny and the Jets. This is Barry Manilow and Mandy at number 4. Right after which we'll crack the magic circle with the top 3 and find out if we got a winner. Of all the albums, all the Acapulco 15 gold songs are on. Right on, Super U. I remember. 1400 WYMO AM and FM stereo reached out a little after 10 p.m. Jeff Mother Allen. With the Acapulco 15, beaten out again this week. Stairway to Heaven, this is Led Zeppelin. At number two.
To heaven.
U100, that's Led Zeppelin, second week in a row at number two. 10:08, Jeff Mother Robbins with a chance of more blowing snow tonight. Low about 10, high tomorrow 25. And U100.
You like the beat?
I like that. U100. So for you with another night guaranteed to get you crazy. The second annual Turkey Trot featuring Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention in concert. It'll be this Wednesday night, 8 at the Civic Center from Schoen and U100 is station with the concert. Jeff Mother Robbins, Elton John, from the soundtrack of Tommy. Once again, by your vote, number one. U100 1014 is Jeff Mother Robbins. If that song was number one, then that would logically make this about zero, which is pretty close to where it's at. Boogie Check coming up in a few minutes. We'll start taking your calls, baby. Stand by. U100 getting you off with a Chicago weekend. More of their greatest hits albums I'm going to give away. Minutes. Stand by.
At the two-pen cycle.
Drug, Red All Family Centers, and at Sears, 7-Eleven food stores, Montgomery Ward, Snyder Brothers, Shopko Music Land, also available at all Target stores. Super U. I'll say 10:19 if you are ready to get down on your mama. If you're ready to get hot and nasty, filled and funky, flagpole it and dog style, I will take your calls. For the world famous Spooky Sex, 452-3333, right now.
What do you feel when you turn off the light?
I don't see nothing but a show.
On a taco stand and done something worthwhile instead of wasting all our time. Silver Convention with Jeff Mother Robbins. Boogie Check is next.
One Theater downtown Minneapolis coming next Friday to the North Star Theater downtown St. Paul. Check your newspaper for showtime.
U100, it's about 10:30 in the city. Jeff Mother Robbins here. Time for the world-famous Boogie Check, where we carry on a typical, normal, run-of-the-mill, everyday, late evening conversation with a bunch of unintelligible rugrats. U100 Boogie Check, hi. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hi, this is Paul. What's going on tonight?
Not much, man. What can I do for you?
Oh, I was thinking of a joke, but it was pretty sad, but I was going to tell you, but I don't know.
Well, don't bother. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Yeah. I want to say something again.
Oh, go right ahead.
Yeah. I wanted to tell all the kids out there who are listening.
Yeah?
That Jeff Mother Robbins is really a nice guy.
How would you know?
Oh, take from me, I know. I heard it from somebody.
You heard it from somebody? Who is this?
I can't tell you. You'd get mad.
I'd get mad?
Oh, definitely. He already got mad for what I said before.
Oh, I did?
No, he did.
Who did?
He did.
Who's he?
You know him.
Oh, I do?
Real well.
Real well?
Yeah, he works down there.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Thanks anyway. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hi, could you play,
No. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hi, am I on Boogie Check?
Yes, you are.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, that's quite all right. Who's this?
Katie O'Brien.
What?
Katie O'Brien and Lisa Lears.
Oh, how old are you guys?
She's 15, and I'm 15, and I'm so upset. God, I'm on Boogie Check.
Oh, I bet you just made your day, didn't it?
Really?
I thought it would.
Lisa just put on the paper, bummer, and God, it's been a great day.
Oh, well, gee, I mean, you know, it just makes me feel so good to add a little sunlight and sunshine and brightness into your otherwise dull metropolitan Twin City day. What can I do for you, Toots?
I want to be on Boogie Check.
You are on Boogie Check right now.
I'm not on the radio.
Yes, you are.
You're kidding.
No.
Oh, can I say hi to a few people?
Sure. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
I got a joke for you.
Okay, man.
Okay, there's these two guys, and they own a garbage place, you know?
Yeah.
And they're driving along, and they have this neighborhood, and they're all filled up. So this one guy has a great idea, and they only have one house left. He has a great idea, he goes, okay, instead of driving all the way across town and then coming back and then pick this up, you put that in, I'll sit on top. He goes, okay, great idea. So then they put it in, they fill it up, and then Gary lays on top. And then the guy on the side says, turn.
100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hey, you know why you and I are so great?
Why?
Because I won 15 albums.
You won 15 albums?
Yeah.
You better go back to school. It's albums.
Oh, so what?
All right, well, you the one who won the Acapulco Gold?
No.
Oh, well, what'd you win?
I got on the Great Record Robbery twice.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, far out, man. You 100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hi, Super 100 is the greatest radio station on the air.
Thank you. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hi, what did the boy do to the girl when he got her up in the tree?
What? U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Mama! Oh, mama! Mama!
U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hi,
Hey, yeah, U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Sorry, man, I...
U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hi.
Yeah, what's going on?
Oh, not much. How's it going?
All right. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Yeah, I got a joke for you.
All right, go ahead.
Yeah, what's purple and white and green?
Yo mama! U100 Boogie Check, hi.
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 Greg.
What?
This is Greg.
Hi, what can I do for you?
Okay, I got a joke for you.
Go ahead, man.
How does a pearl commit suicide?
How?
Jumps out of the basement window.
Yes. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
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 You gonna tell a joke?
Go right ahead, man.
Okay. Well, there's a German.
Yeah.
A Mexican.
Yeah.
A Texan.
Yeah.
An Englishman.
Yeah.
And a Frenchman.
Uh-huh.
And they're flying in a plane.
Yeah. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
I've got a poem for you.
Okay. Go ahead. Lay it on me.
Okay. There was a girl named Molly Brown who said that...
U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Hey, Jeff, I got a poem for you.
Oh, go ahead.
Little Jack Horner.
U100 Boogie Check, hi. Hello. Thanks a lot. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
This is the thoroughly outrageous Jeff Mother Robbins.
In the flesh, man.
Hey, you're really doing a good job tonight.
Thanks a lot, man. What can I do for you?
Keep it going.
Huh?
Keep it going.
I always do. U100 Boogie Check, hi.
Yeah, did you hear about the new Polish parachute?
No.
It opens on impact.
U100, give me the honky tonk Lenny Stones. Jeff Mother Robbins here, 1039. How you doing?
Listen.
Time to forget my feelings of love. Rolling down on my face, trying to forget my feelings of life.
U100, Elton John, and Jeff Mother Robbins on a Chicago weekend at 10:47.
You and me.
326.
And the instant rip is the closest you fall right now. Score Elton John's new album and an autograph to Rock. Go to West East at 452-3333. I'll take number 9. Chicago. Sunny for the weekend. Hazardous driving conditions continue. Low tonight, about 10. High 25 tomorrow. Jeff Mother Robbins here, 11:05. U100, I got more Chicago's greatest hits albums to give away coming up in a couple minutes. It's 11:10.
Super hit, the Pacific.
U100 is your number one boogie station. U100 getting out of your request for Sky High. That's Jigsaw. This is Jeff Mother Robbins at 11:17. High noon. U100. 100. This is Jeff Miller Robbins. It's 11:24. Taking care of about 8 million requests for Simon and Garfunkel. My Little Town. Vices are not habits, it's the album. This is the Doobie Brothers in Blackwater. U100 with more winners than any Twin City radio station, man. 11:30, Jeff Mother Robbins on a Chicago weekend. More Insta Rips are minutes away. 34 with the Immigrant Song, Jeff Mother and Led Zeppelin. 11:36, Jeff Mother Robbins and the Bay City Rollers. U100, this is Jeff Mother Robbins, 11:38 at 452-3333. A couple foxy little ladies wanted to hear Gracie Slick and a Jefferson Starship from Red Octopus and Miracles, baby. U100 is your number one boogie station. U100, 11:45 on a Chicago weekend. This is Jeff Mother Robbins. 452-3333. I'm getting out all your favorites in stereo tonight. This is John Denver from Windsong. U100 presents the BBC Rolling Stones concert special this Sunday night. You catch it at 10 right on Super U. Super U, we're going to give you our big Christmas presents early. Get ready for December 6th, Saturday night, at the St. Paul Civic Center. A rock and roll concert featuring Montrose, Foghat, and the one and only Black Oak, Arkansas. Hot man, nasty. U100 is brand new from Black Oak, Arkansas, called Strong Enough to Be Gentle. 11:56, Jeff Mother Robbins here. Led Zeppelin. U100, WIRO, AM and FM, Stereo Richfield. This is y'all mama at midnight. U100, save the seals weather. For everybody ice skating down Cedar Avenue and all the freeways this evening, just because it hasn't snowed since this morning don't mean the roads still ain't horrible, man. Low 10 tonight, and there's a chance of some more high winds and local blowing and dripping snow. High later today, 25. Sizzling, 12:05, PG. U100, 12:08. Time for all good boys and girls to be asleep. Time for all bad boys and girls to be in bed. U100 reminds you to help out some kids who might otherwise not have anything to celebrate this Christmas. Bring your new or slightly used toys to any Twin City 7-Eleven store. He's dropping off for the U100 U.S. Marine Toys to Tots campaign. 12:17, KC and the Sunshine Band. U100 boogies on all night long with the snowman at 1. I got some more Insta Rips on a Chicago weekend in minutes. You just stand by and keep it right on Super U. U100 is your number one boogie station. U100 1226, the Black Sabbath. U100, a little after 12:30 in the cities. This is Diamond Time, brought to you by J. Gerber Jewelers, 385 Office Show, downtown St. Paul. Famous for diamonds for 90 years. U100, Jeff Mother Robbins on a Chicago weekend, 12:35. With Chicago's greatest hits album, we will be giving away all night long. Stand by for your chance to win. U100, Chicago, and Jeff Mother Robbins here, 12:41.
Now.
You can drop off any new or slightly used toy at the Twin City 7-Eleven stores and do your part for the U100 U.S. Marine Corps Toys for Tots campaign. U100 and Neil Sedaka, 12:49.
Hey, what are you doing?
12:50, that's it for me, Jeff Mother Robbins. I'll catch you back Sunday afternoon at 1. Snowman is there, Snowball is next. Have a nice night, have a good trip, and stay high. I'm going home and get some fresh pie. Chocolate cream.
Hey, I love you.
Bye. Goodbye. Woo! Woo! 1253, you have been listening to Diamond Time, brought to you by J. Gerber Jewelers at 385 Wabashaw, downtown St. Paul, famous for diamonds for 90 years. And now, ahead of more music on the Art Snow Show, here's Art Snow.
And now, hi.
Do you have any matches in there?
Hi. Oh, yeah, I got some.
I'll be right in.
Matches? Okay, got lots of them. Okay, right. Are we ready?
It's time this morning for a little cold weather, which we could use. It's getting colder all the time. It's going to be the coldest night of the year so far. It'll be down around 6 degrees. That's what we're predicted for this morning. And maybe not quite so cold tomorrow morning, if you call it 10 degrees, not quite so cold. And maybe some of this stuff will, for the most part, get all the way off the streets and driveways today when it goes up to a nice sunny 28 or 29. The U.S. draws its resolution on worldwide amnesty for political prisoners. It's withdrawing it completely, as a matter of fact. 15 amendments were tacked to the original proposal, making it ineffective in the eyes of the U.S. delegation. Daniel Patrick Manahan added to speculation that he's resigning as U.S. ambassador to the United Nations, when he abruptly called off a news conference Friday. But the outspoken Monahan denied the rumors when questioned by reporters. 6 of the 13 Republican governors meeting in Wichita, Kansas, signed a pledge yesterday to support President Ford in his campaign for the GOP presidential nomination. There were indications that 4 more will add their names before the end of that 3-day session. A plane occupied by Congressman Morris Udall of Arizona and 14 other passengers came to a jolting halt at Waterloo, Iowa Municipal Airport last night when it rolled into mud. No one was injured except for Mr. Mudd in what Udall calls a non-event. Congressman John Dingell said he suspects natural gas producers are contributing to a shortage by holding back supplies to force the government to lift price controls. He said a study by the Library of Congress shows producers could hold back output and still make a profit years from now if price controls are dropped. Federal investigators say the crew of an Eastern Airlines jet did see fireballs late Wednesday afternoon over Virginia. But the investigators say the crew was mistaken to think they were missile engines. Apparently, the lights came from a meteor shower. Okay. Hundreds of persons remain stranded in the plains in Upper Midwest yesterday as snow removal crews tackled the drifts left by that 3-day pre-Thanksgiving blizzard. 8 persons so far have lost their lives in the storm, which dumped up to 20 inches of snow across 1,200 miles. Money slipped through the fingers of 2 bank robbers in a Sicilian village faster than they expected yesterday. They accidentally dropped half their loot of nearly $15,000 during their getaway. The news is a little hard up this morning. State authorities say at least 5 deaths have been reported in the winter storm that buried parts of Minnesota. Up to 24 inches of snow. Nobles County authorities say 31-year-old Alan Smetana of Chicago was found dead in a stranded car by a road crew this morning on Interstate 90 about 5 miles west of Worthington in the hard-hit southwestern corner of the state. According to the county coroner, Dr. E.A. Kilbride, Smetana apparently died of exposure to the cold. 4 other deaths were attributed to heart attacks, 1 Granite Falls man who was putting on snow tires, and 3 Twin City men who were shoveling snow. Governor Anderson says he does not recommend that Senator Hubert Humphrey become involved in the presidential primaries, but Anderson said he would like to see Humphrey be the party's presidential nominee. And on another matter, Anderson said Minneapolis Mayor Al Hofstede, who lost his bid for re-election this month, has not asked about getting a state job. But in the governor's words, if he did ask, I would be very receptive. Anderson calls Hofstede a very talented man. Senator Hubert Humphrey warns that yesterday's announcement about reduction in Canadian oil support, export rather, gives Minnesota only 2 years to locate alternative oil supplies. The Minnesota Democrat said in a statement yesterday that landlocked northern tier refineries, including the 3 in Minnesota, need a 250,000 barrels of oil a day from Canada. According to Humphrey, Canadians say that exports to the U.S. will decline to 385,000 barrels a day by mid-1976. This means by January 1978 or so, the export will fall under the 250,000 barrels a day needed. Lakehead University of Thunder Bay, Ontario defeated Bemidji State University 1-0 last night at an International Collegiate Hockey Association game in Bemidji. Elsewhere, our Minnesota Gopher hockey team was defeated in a WCHA game by Michigan State by a score of 3-1. Minnesota quarterback Tony Dungy, the Big Ten's top passer, faces a double threat today. Coming from both the weather and the Wisconsin pass defense, the best in the Big Ten and the third best in the country. Heavy snows struck our area late this week, and while they've abated, the temperatures will not be very conducive for a passing attack. But Wisconsin coach John Jardine isn't having any of that talk. He said the players found the field in good condition after a workout yesterday, and thus the weather should have no bearing on the game. The Gophers are 5-5 overall, just 2-5 in the Big Ten, though. They're 4-point favorites over Wisconsin, 4-5-1 overall, and third in the conference with a 3-3-1 mark. Coach Cal Soule is wary of the Minnesota, of the Wisconsin pass defense, but he's more concerned with the ability of his defense to stop the Badgers' Billy Morick, who really knows how to run that ball. U100 WIO AM and FM stereo, Ridgefield, reminds you emphysema is a nightmare if you smoke heavily cut down. If you don't smoke, why bother to start? U100 Save the Seals weather clear and cooler this morning. The low should be about 6 above, mostly sunny today with a high about 28 above, partly cloudy and little change tonight, down to about 10 above. Right now in the Twin Cities, it's 19 and partly cloudy. I'm Art Snow for the new Super U. U100-104, we're a little early with that one. Saturday night's all right for fighting. Friday night, you know, you just sort of slap a little bit. U100, where you can drop off any new or slightly used toy in any Twin Cities 7-Eleven store. Do your part for the U100 U.S. Marine Corps Toy for Tots campaign. Thank you very much. 106, the Twin. U100 out of Chicago, we go with plays and giveaways of Chicago. LPs all weekend long. Brand new Best of Chicago. And the BBC Rolling Stone concert coming up tomorrow night, 10 o'clock. Right on, right on, Super U. Deep Purple from Purple Passages, Hush. Save the Seals weather, 115, Twin Cities. We can expect a low this morning of about 6 degrees. Isn't that wonderful? And a high today under fairly sunny skies of about 20. Back down to 10 tonight. 19 right now, Super U Chicago on a Chicago weekend beginnings. U100 Snowman on a Chicago weekend is beginning. Chicago. Remember this morning, 6 o'clock, Jerry St. James on the Super U along with Rex King and all the other good people saving the seals. This is Diamond Time. So this year you can light into fall radiantly and do that with the brilliance of a Northern Star Diamond from J.A. Gerber Jewelers on Wabashaw between 5th and 6th in downtown St. Paul. Gerber's is the exclusive home of the Northern Star Diamond. That's the world's very brightest diamond. It's imported from Antwerp, Belgium, and it's guaranteed in writing for life. Now, the Northern Star means sheer radiance in an exciting range of dazzling and elegant designs. 14-karat white gold, yellow gold, antique finishes. All with the help of one of Gerber's diamond experts, that thought that you've had in your head about your very own setting, the one with the skull and crossbones on it. They'll help you create that. Quicken your step. Don't feel like you have to dress up or anything like that. Come as you are down to the warm and caring atmosphere of Gerber Jewelers Store. Just pour yourself a cup of coffee. Look around unhurriedly. When you made your choice, go ahead and charge it. You pay no interest. You pay no carrying charge on your new account. And the diamond you choose today can be traded in for its full present value on a new and a larger Northern Star diamond in the future. You can shop any weekday, and that includes today, right up to 5:30 in the afternoon, Monday and Thursday evenings until 9. At J.A. Gerber Jewelers, you get individual and professional attention because they care about you, Gerbers. G-E-R-B-E-R, 385 Wabashaw, downtown St. Paul. Not a chain store, but one magnanimous, magnifico, magnificent jewelry store, famous for diamonds for 90 years. U100 Olivia, 126 Super U, Snowman, and Blackhawk, Arkansas, Jim Dandy from X-Rated. They'll be here early December, along with Foghat, brought to you by Super U in concert once again. Strong enough to be gentle. To Diamond Time, brought to you by J.A. Gerber Jewelers at 385 Wabashaw in downtown St. Paul. Famous for diamonds for 90 years. This is Diamond Time, brought to you by J.A. Gerber Jewelers, the home of the Northern Star Diamond, 385 Wabashaw in downtown St. Paul. I'm John Island Girl. You're listening to Diamond Time on the Super U 135.
Hey, what are you doing?
U100 by request. Free bird. Reminding you, U100 disc jockeys are available for appearances at your school. A obscene or otherwise. For more information, just drop a line to U100 2110 Cliff Road, Egan 55122. Instant Rebus is close to your phone. 12th caller, 452-3333. For someone I used to nap in the morning, found there was no profit in it, 5,000 volts. J.C. James presents Rex King and the Hot Flight Newscast. Michael D. Douglas and much more Monday morning right here on the Super U. Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young almost cut my hair. The one right there behind my left ear. U100 Chicago Weekend almost cut my hair. Arr, arr, arr. 150 to Twin Cities with Snowman Jeff Father Robbins, letting you put your mama anywhere you choose. He'll be doing that Sunday afternoon, 1 o'clock, on the Super U. You're listening to Diamond Time. U100, you're listening to Diamond Time, brought to you by Jacob Jewelers, 385 Wabasha, downtown St. Paul, famous for diamonds for 90 years. U100, the Snowman, presenting our Thanksgiving turkey to you one day early. Shone and the Super U present Frank Zappa Wednesday night, 8 o'clock, St. Paul Civic Center, from Shone and U100 the station with the concerts. 203 in Twin Cities, from Pick of the Litter, Spinners, Games, People Play. Super U, this boogie station in North America. And here's Santana, by request. Soul Sacrifice. This is for both Brooklyn Center and Anoka. Whatever they have in common. Definitely for Minneapolis, too. U100 Santana. 215. Super U. 19 degrees in Twin Cities by request. Eagles. Say the Seals weather. Color mostly sunny today. Color low tonight about 6 and the high today about 28 if we're lucky. It's 19 right now. It's Super U. Orleans from Let There Be Music and Dance with Me. Whirl, twirl, stomp on me, kick. No. U100, good morning. Jerry St. James had a good time out at Cheapskate, and all you good people out there got your X King buttons and everything. Tune in Jerry this morning. He'll be talking about it. 6 o'clock right here on the Super U. Eagles, Lion Eyes. U100, Snowman reminding you, the mana. We'll be with you at 1 o'clock Sunday afternoon on the Super U, letting you put your mama anywhere you want. Chicago, it's the Chicago Weekend with plays and giveaways to the great Chicago Greatest Hits LP all weekend long. Question 67 and 68. When it gets good, they stop. U100 Snowman, good morning. 238, the Twins Electric Light Orchestra. Face the Music. Evil Woman. And it presents our Thanksgiving turkey. We'll give it to you one day early. Shone and the Super U giving you Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention Wednesday night, 8 o'clock, St. Paul Civic Center. From Shone and U100, the station with the concert. By request, Eric and the Dominoes, Clapton and Layla. Hello, Matter of Money, Jerry St. James, 6 o'clock this morning on the Super U. Morris Albert, Feelings. U100, 251 in the Twin Cities, by the numbers LP, the Who. Mama's got a squeeze box. and I mean that nicely. Musically, I mean. Mommy's got a rhinestone cowboy. You want Hunter Glenn Campbell. U100 wants you to help a kid who might not otherwise have anything to celebrate. Bring him any new or slightly used toy to any Twin City 7-Eleven store. Give it to the U100 U.S. Marine Corps Toy for Tots campaign. This is ABBA. U100-305 in the Twin Cities by request on the Super U on a cold Saturday morning. Elton John, Tiny Dancer. U100 is the Chicago weekend. Plays and giveaways to the greatest of Chicago. All weekend long on the Super U, cultivating 10 o'clock.
You are my love and my life.
U100 Chicago weekend, save a seal's weather. Going down to 6 degrees tonight. Mostly sunny and about 28 for a high. I certainly hope so today. 16 Super U, Olivia.
Rudy?
That's Olivia, Ian Evie, he's my brother. My brother's about 614 pounds. But only after a heavy meal. Simon and Garfunkel. My Little Town. Jerry St. James on the Super U this morning at 6 o'clock. U100 Chicago weekend. Remember, the Rolling Stone special is coming up, 10 o'clock. BBC special, Sunday night on the Super U. Light my fire. U100, Snowman, 326 in the Twin Cities. Make it 16 degrees by request, KC, and the Sunshine Band. And that's the way I like it. News in length this morning. Good morning. I'm a snowman, and yes, it is the extended news in length. For Michael C. Douglas, who is not here on vacation, that means I got to talk for a long time this morning.
Here's a run.
So, without further ado, here we go. If I get tired, I'll grab a few shut eyes here. Maybe you might want to, too. We'll be back with music before too long, I hope. The 16-month-long divorce case of Jackie Gleason and his second wife has come to an end. Circuit Court Judge Robert Tyson in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, issued an order awarding Beverly Gleason a lump sum alimony of 150,000 bills. Tyson also allowed her to keep the couple's $7,000 Mercedes and a number of personal items and gifts given her by the 60-year-old entertainer. The judge ruled against Mrs. Gleason's claim to the 14-room, 8-bath home at Inverary and a request for $70,000 alimony. But the final split appeared to be amicable. Mrs. Gleason, who's 43 years old, said, "I am satisfied and I wish Jack all the happiness in the world." Both were present at the hearing yesterday, sitting on opposite sides of a table, just as they had lived in opposite ends of Gleason's house during the nearly year and a half of the court fight. Tyson said after what he called an extended honeymoon of only 7 months, the Gleason marriage began to fall apart, most definitely. Well, there's a new program to rehabilitate heart patients. It was presented a couple of days ago at a medical conference in Atlanta, and doctors say they are astounded with the results they've gotten so far. The plan involves a diet that strictly controls the intake of all fat, coupled with an exercise program. A significant factor in the program is the reversal of hardening of the arteries through diet. It's quite a breakthrough there. A North Carolina Research Institute reports roughly 28% of the nation's students in grades 7 through 12 are problem drinkers. If you thought you were all alone out there because you boozed up and you're a kid, oh, you're not alone. A lot of people do it. The study, prepared for the National Institute of Alcohol Abuse and Alcoholism, also says about one out of every four 13-year-olds can be considered a moderate drinker. That's amazing. And started early, down the wrong road. A former bodyguard to billionaire Howard Hughes says that Hughes spent countless hours in the nude, watching movies while his aides crawled around his private theater, killing flies. The ex-bodyguard, Ron Kistler, writing in the December issue of Playboy magazine, said the aides were instructed in the proper way to kill a fly by Hughes personally, who was deathly afraid of germs. According to Kistler, no fly swatters, newspapers or magazines, sticky paper or wax or spray cans were allowed. You had to cover your hand with Kleenex so the hand would not come into direct contact with the enemy, the fly. After each fly was killed, Hughes reportedly demanded that the insect's body be shown to him personally, held by the aide who caught it. According to Kistler, Hughes would sometimes say, "Hey, that's a nice fly, Ron," or "You were real quick on that one, hey boy." $2.5 billion he's got. And he's got to be weird. In a case similar to the highly politicized Joan Little trial, this is from Earth News, two black women from South Georgia have been indicted for first-degree murder in the shotgun death of a white insurance salesman. The two defendants, Cheryl Todd, 24, and Desi Woods, 30, claimed that while hitchhiking, they were offered a ride by Ronnie Horn, who proceeded to make sexual advances and threaten them with a gun. Though the defendants admit taking $152 from Horn's wallet, they claim the salesman died as a result of a struggle over the pistol. The prosecution is expected to argue that the two women lured Holmes to a secluded spot where they planned to kill him and rob him. As in the Little case, women's organizations are supporting the accused women by organizing a defense committee and appealing for funds on a nationwide basis. On January 12th, Georgia Superior Court Judge James O'Connor is expected to rule on a change of venue for that trial and whether or not the two defendants will be tried together. The prosecution has promised to recommend no more than the penalty of life in prison if the two women are tried together. The prestigious Columbia University Graduate School of Business is talking trash these days. And what it says is that private garbage collections are much more efficient than municipal trash collection services. That means lower costs, a whole bunch lower. The report said private trash haulers can provide twice-a-week curbside pickup service at 69% less cost than the city agencies can. The director of the study said this is because of a combination of factors lumped under the heading of governmental inefficiency. He says municipal crews are usually larger, they use smaller trucks, they spend more time at each house, they visit fewer houses during a shift, and they have a higher rate of absenteeism. This is partly because the cities do not offer employee incentives the way commercial enterprises do. Thought you might want to know that. Then again, maybe you don't. Well, it doesn't really matter. Health consultant Roger Smith said more teenage girls are smoking now than they did in 1970. In an American Lung Association report, Smith said the number of girls smoking is almost equal to the number of boys now. He said the Lung Association is starting a program aimed at deglamorizing smoking by pointing out its health hazards. Federal Aviation Administration says it's trying to determine how four missiles or rockets may have zipped past an Eastern Airlines flight south of Richmond, Virginia. The DC-9 was carrying 89 persons en route from Florida to Washington. The pilot and co-pilot both reported seeing missiles pass near the twin-engine jet shortly after it adjusted altitude to approach Washington's National Airport. Some wedding bells on Capitol Hill. House Ways and Means Committee members Andy Jacobs of Indiana and Martha Keys of Kansas say they're going to get married. The marriage of the two Democrats apparently will mark the first time two House members from the same Congress have wed. I think it's really sweet. In Earth News, the government sometimes works in wondrous ways which normal men may never understand. Well, you already heard this. Okay, I won't go to that. It's dull, dead, and boring anyhow, so we'll skip that, all right? All right. Hurdles have been cleared for a series of regional question and answer television programs for presidential candidates next spring. The Federal Election Commission informally rule that the League of Women Voters may accept corporate contributions to help finance the program. Such corporate gifts, the commissioners said, do not constitute illegal political contributions. Closely keyed to the 1976 primary election schedule, the programs will be taped for television before live audiences in Massachusetts, Florida, New York, and California. The candidate sessions will not be debates, but programs in which the candidates will answer questions on selected issues. Disagreeing with the equal time ruling, the election commissioners indicated that the league will not have to include all of the present 30 presidential candidates on the programs. That's nice. It's also dull, dead, and boring. Boy, there's so much dead and boring news, even in Earth news. Of course, everything can't be good. The New World Liberation Front, this from the Zodiac, in a written communique, is taking credit for the sabotage of nearly 1,000 parking meters in San Francisco over last weekend. The two-page communique explains that the meters were plugged up with glue or vandalized to protest a wave of parking tickets handed out by San Francisco police during the last 2 weeks. Immediately following November 4th city elections, when San Francisco voters enacted ballot measures opposed by the police, an unprecedented number of parking tickets were handed out to parked cars across the city. The NWLF communique also contains instructions on how willing citizens can disable meters. The police department acknowledges that at least several hundred meters have been found with their locks jammed by epoxy glue.
Woo!
All right. Well, let's get into some Starship stuff. You might be interested in hearing about that. John Denver's Oriental language lessons proved fruitless during his recent Japanese concert tour. Hoping for an audience sing-along, he crooned Take Me Home, Country Roads in Japanese. Much to his dismay, the packed house responded in English.
Wasuka! Yes, a foreign country place.
Oshinevicha. Six of the 14 movie Tarzans, all garbed in loincloths, met in San Diego recently for a nostalgic shrieking bout, which will be aired on the Mike Douglas Show this week. 71-year-old Johnny Weissmuller, who originated the Tarzan yell, was the winner of the yelling contest, loudly beating out the other Tarzans in the decibel department. Due to the attention their album, Wind on the Water, has brought regarding the plight of the whale, David Crosby and Graham Nash recently received individual award plaques from the Humane Society. Marvin Gaye and Quincy Jones headline a benefit for Glide Memorial Church at the Cow Palace in San Francisco November 30th. And Jose Feliciano will make his TV comedy debut on an upcoming Chico and the Man show. Isn't that a biggie? Really dig that? Having just completed his first major film role, The Man Who Fell to Earth, David Bowie now decided to form his own film company called Bewley Brothers Incorporated, although no film projects have yet been set. It's expected a film version of Ziggy Stardust will be his company's debut movie. But while he's getting his movie trip together, David will release a new single this week. And it's called Golden Years and was culled from Bowie's sessions for his next album. The album, meanwhile, features a great lineup of musicians, including Roy Bittan, the keyboard player in Bruce Springsteen's E Street Band, and guitarist Earl Slick, who played on Bowie's last American tour. Also helping out on the sessions were Alice Cooper, Peter Frampton, Bobby Womack, and Rod Wood. Bowie's now planning a major worldwide tour to coincide with the release of the album early next year. That's another biggie. A rock concert version of Butterball and the Grasshopper Feast, a children's book of verse and animal sketches, has recently been made into a film. The concert, which took place at London's Albert Hall, featured horror movie veteran Vincent Price reading poems to a rock score composed and sung by ex-Deep Purple member Roger Clover. Other participants included model actress Twiggy and Deep Purple members David Covervale and Glenn Hughes and the 60-piece orchestra. Dick Clark's fourth annual New Year's Rockin' Eve TV special will headline Neil Sedaka with the Average White Band, Freddie Fender, Casey and the Sunshine Band, and Melissa Manchester. Red Fox is signed with Atlantic Records. He'll soon release his first recording in 12 years entitled, get this, You Gotta Wash Your Ass. That's the name of it. The set was recorded live at New York's Apollo Theater. I certainly hope so for his sake. Tony Basil has been set to choreograph the production for Bette Midler's upcoming 20-city, 80-performance concert tour. That's a biggie. Tony, who's been dubbed the Ginger Rogers of rock, is the dance director of The Lockers, a highly acclaimed rock dance ensemble, which has appeared on such television shows as The Tonight Show, Midnight Special, and Soul Train. Tony's jazz choreography credits also include David Bowie's Diamond Dogs Tour, such hit films as American Graffiti, The Monkey's Head, and Roberta Flack's television special. As an actress, she appeared in Easy Rider, Five Easy Pieces, and Greaser's Palace, to name a few. For the Divine Miss M, Tony will arrange and direct the dance numbers. They'll accompany Bette's performances. Among the numbers scheduled for production, elements of Bette's musical Broadway show, Clams on the Half Shell Review, as well as selections from her new album, Songs for the New Depression, set for release December 1st. There was a demand for seats at Al Green's recent two-night stand at Sahara in Las Vegas. The reports were reportedly going as high as $1,500 per table. Among the celebrities who made it were the Jackson Five, now known as the Jackson Family, The Fifth Dimension, Julia Prowse, Fats Domino, Jeff Baxter, and Keith Knudsen of the Doobie Brothers. Meanwhile, the Doobies made a few marks of their own, breaking 15 attendance records on a just-completed national tour, topping marks previously held by such rock heavyweights as Elton John and Elvis Presley. Continuing on, as we are wont to do, Bernie Taupin, Elton John's lyricist, is off to Canada, where he'll begin cutting his second solo album. Keith Emerson is reportedly making a solo album with the 95-piece London Philharmonic Orchestra. Isn't that interesting? Can David Essex, England's number one pop singer, win over American fans? Well, if the crowds who turned out for Essex's American debut are any indication of his popularity, Essex has definitely made it in the USA. In Los Angeles, requests for tickets were so overwhelming that extra shows had to be added to Essex's itinerary, and lines of people waiting to get standing room only tickets stretched for three blocks outside Los Angeles' Roxy Theater. Besides attracting enormous crowds, Essex also drew a host of rock stars to his debut performances. Elton John, Ringo Starr, Robert Plant, Rod Stewart, and Britt Eklund, Janis Ian, Johnny Mantis, Harry Nilsson, all were among the luminaries on hand for the shows. And since Essex managed to tape three television shows while in L.A., you'll soon see him for yourself on either the Cher Show, the Midnight Special Rock Concert, or the Merv Griffin Show. Remember Pete Best? Anybody ever remember Pete Best? You know who he was? The drummer that the Beatles dumped in favor of Ringo when they were just getting started? Pete Best was recently busted in England for cocaine. Got himself a very stiff 5-year sentence out of that. Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes walked off the stage at the recent opening at the Los Angeles Playboy Club because no professional courtesies were extended to them. According to Melvin, the group was expected to dress in the public restrooms and play despite the fact that one of the members of the group came down with an unexpected illness. Conditions such as poor lighting and sound were not conducive for myself and the group to remain, said Melvin. Casey Geller, manager of the LA Playboy Club, said the show was closed because basically Melvin and the Blue Notes had internal problems that could not be solved. Joe Cocker, Old Iron Throat, currently recording in Kingston, Jamaica, said his new album will be reggae-oriented. The LP is scheduled for release early next year. It features a new lineup of backup musicians, including Gordon Edwards on bass, Cornell Dupree and Eric Gale on guitars, and Steve Gadd on drums. That pretty well takes care of it as far as the music news this morning goes. You know, a group of Americans this week placed a memorial wreath over the English grave of that great American revolutionary hero, Benedict Arnold. At least the members of the Arnold Society say he was a hero. Doesn't care what you think. Their avowed mission is to clear Arnold's name and to reestablish him as the greatest field officer who ever lived. Society President Vincent Linder claims that a recent Army review of Arnold's court-martial was full of contradictions and bias. He intends to launch a campaign for the full reversal of the 1780 court-martial, which made the name Benedict Arnold an epithet for traitor. Linder claims that Arnold's offer to sell West Point to the British was nothing more than a fairy tale perpetrated by hanging judges disguised as historians. Well, the Foremost Foods Company of San Francisco is studying a proposal to convert an estimated annual 13 billion pounds of whey, you know what whey is, the fluid byproduct of cheese making, into booze. Little Miss Muffet's had on her tuffet, you know, getting stoned on her curds and whey. Initial tests conducted by Oregon State University indicate the plan could produce wine that is both inexpensive and tasty. Curiously, the research is being supported by a $113,000 grant from the Environmental Protection Agency. The EPA is involved because of the disposal problems caused by all that whey. Representative Horton E. Stark of California termed the grant indulgence in a ridiculous product, a ridiculous project also. In fact, that's a ridiculous story. Whey wine, just what I always wanted. Can you imagine drinking a cheesy Chablis? Well, let's see what else we've got here. Boy, it's beginning to get very,
very, very boring.
Beginning to get. It was boring 15 minutes ago, and it's getting even more boring. Well, we could sit around and pick hairs out of each other's armpits or something like that. I suppose I should do a little more here. Congressman Michael Cullen of Michigan said Ohio State fans are full of baloney anyway, so he's betting 10 pounds of the stuff against an Ohio ham being wagered by Representative Mike Oxley of Ohio. The bet is for the Ohio State-Michigan game being played tomorrow. Conlon also claims the Ohio State legislature has passed a resolution declaring the phrase "go blue" an obscenity. He says the lawmaking body has instructed Ohio's Secretary of State not to reissue personalized license plates, bearing those words to a Wolverine fan who lives in Ohio. Oh, terrible, terrible, terrible. We've been talking about this for a while. Well, it's finally happened. Charleston, West Virginia have finally got their person who gets to blow up the bridge. Housewife Barbara Oros has won that contest. She gets to blow up the Kanawha City Bridge. She'll do it Sunday morning. That's right. Mayor John Hutchison pulled Mrs. Oros' entry out of a box. She moved to Charleston 6 months ago, and simply she wanted to blow up the obsolete structure because, quote, "it'll be the most exciting thing I've done since moving to Charleston," unquote. Sunday's also her husband's birthday, and Mrs. Oros says that's how they're going to celebrate it. Mother and babies are doing fine, but Daddy fainted. 34-year-old Rosa Ciavarella gave birth to quadruplets yesterday in a Massafara, Italy hospital. Hospital doctors say the father has since recovered from his fainting spell. Nevada gaming experts say having a $100,000 jackpot on slot machines is a nice idea, but it's not really fair. The experts say the $100,000 jackpot would occur only once every 48,000 years. Mike Choi allegedly tried to rob a drugstore yesterday, but he forgot where he put a key. San Francisco police say Choi ordered the drugstore owner to lock the door and to give him the key. He then took $35 from the cash register and several items from the store's shelves. But when he was ready to leave, he couldn't find the key. Couldn't get out. By the time he did, police had arrived. Claire Tommy said it's not the same when she kisses her husband, so a Detroit jury awarded the couple $275 in damages. Mrs. Tommy underwent a dental operation in 1968, and since then she has had no feeling in her lower lip or jaw. By the way, you know that you can spit on somebody and not have them get mad at you? That's right. If you're in Tanzania, it is proper to spit at somebody. The Maasai tribesmen of Tanzania spit at each other to show respect and goodwill. Try that on your boss when you go to work today. Let's see what else is new here. Oh, boy. It's really a bad news day. Most days are called bad news days around here. Former U.S. Customs agents in El Paso, Texas are charging that a U.S. grand jury investigation of alleged corruption within customs is a whitewash and a cover-up. The National Observer quotes two former agents who have admitted participating in phony drug seizures, illegal break-ins and buggings, and even told tales of murder and kidnapping by custom agents. This is from Earth News. One of the agents, Mike Kelly, said he testified before the grand jury along with about three dozen other agents, but Kelly says the jury never asked me about all of that when I testified. They didn't want to hear about it. It's just another cover-up because so many customs people are involved. According to the agents, customs personnel periodically flew into Mexico to an area where wacky weed smugglers are known to load aircraft. The agents seized hundreds of pounds of unguarded wacky weed and fly it back over the border to the U.S. The catch is then left in the area on the U.S. side of the border for other agents to find and report as confiscated contraband. The agents say such a system is used to produce good statistics for the Customs Bureau and to make the Drug Enforcement Agency look bad. Customs and DEA have been locked in a battle for several years over who has the proper investigatory function in international drug smuggling. The El Paso grand jury is still in session, and no report on the investigation has as yet been announced. What else have we got? A rock concert version of Butterball and the Grasshopper Feast, a children's book of verse and animal sketches, has recently been made into a film. The concert, which took place at London's Albert Hall, featured horror movie veteran Vincent Price reading poems to a rock score, composed and sung by ex-Deep Purple member Roger Clover. Other participants included model actress Twiggy and Deep Purple members David Cloverdale and Coverdale, rather, and Glenn Hughes, and a 60-piece orchestra. Nine presidential candidates will gather at a three-day Democratic forum that meets this week in Louisville, Kentucky. They're debating a plan for replacing the American capitalist economy with a planned socialist economy. The plan, a product of a three-year study by economists Gar Alperovitz and Jeff Falls, is not a position of the Democratic Forum, but a paper to stimulate discussion, says Keith Haller, executive director of the forum. The paper envisions a planned society that guarantees a job for everybody, price controls on three-quarters of all consumer goods, public ownership of major industries, and governmental control over natural resources and capital. The proposal is based on the belief that as America's natural resources dry up, somebody will have to plan their future use. Capitalist corporations, because of their need to expand, are not the best candidates for that job, or so say the economists. The United Auto Workers International Executive Board has voted to protest the General Motors decision to undertake a vast auto and small truck assembly operation in Chile. GM, Hugo Renault, and Fiat have been awarded contracts to reorganize and expand auto assembly plants abandoned by foreign corporations during the popularly elected government of Dr. Salvador Allende. The UAW's actions expected to boost projects and prospects in the U.S. Congress for a bill to withhold foreign aid from the Chilean military government. All that's from Earth News. Let's see if we got something else here from Earth News. Oh, here's something. Two highly respected Swedish daily newspapers have accused the National Caucus of Labor Committees, the NCLC, of being a CIA-financed organization whose purpose is to discredit the left and infiltrate and disrupt legitimate socialist and Marxist organizations. The NCLC, or NICLX, frequently appear at leftist political meetings in the U.S. where they routinely charge that all political activity, excepting their own, of course, is coordinated by a fascist conspiracy consisting of Nelson Rockefeller and the CIA. The newspapers quoted members of the Swedish Social Democratic and Communist parties who said that NCLC affiliates had infiltrated their parties, attempted to get information, and suggested sabotage activities. The NCLC and its subsidiary organizations, the U.S. Labor Party, the International Press Service, and the European Labor Committees, all claim to be Marxist organizations dedicated to the overthrow of the so-called Rockefeller Empire and the CIA. Yet the NCLC has borrowed $548,000 from the Rockefeller-owned Chase Manhattan Bank on a security worth only $16,000. Besides the Chase Manhattan loan, the NCLC, which operates a series of regional offices and an expensive telex system, has no other visible means of support. One of the Swedish newspapers quoted a former CIA agent, Philip Agee, as saying that the NCLC is without a doubt a secret right-wing organization, and its activities in Europe perfectly fit the model for a normal CIA operation. That's what the man say. I'm gonna slap myself a couple of times, keep myself awake. Ow, ooh. What a warning. There must be something else. Hang on, people, it's almost over. CBS News reports it's scheduled 2 one-hour television specials on the John Kennedy assassination for Tuesday and Wednesday night of next week. The programs, titled The American Assassins, will explore the question of whether Lee Harvey Oswald was the assassin and whether he was acting alone. The program, according to the network, will feature a showing of the home movie of the Dallas assassination, filmed by Abraham Zapruder, and will include a frame-by-frame computer analysis of the Zapruder film in an effort to pinpoint exactly when President Kennedy and Governor John Connally were struck by bullets. Critics of CBS special are already attacking the fact that the program is being produced by Leslie Midgley. Midgley also produced a similar four-part CBS special on the JFK case back in 1967, which, while acknowledging major discrepancies in the Warren Commission investigation, concluded that the commission was correct in naming Oswald as the lone assassin. That's from the Zodiac. Also in the Zodiac, ballet dancer Rudolf Nureyev has beaten out David Bowie for the lead role in Ken Russell's movie on Rudolf Valentino. The film will be shot in London. It'll probably be buried there, too. The newspaper, Newsday, reports that four key aides in the Nixon administration who were influential in developing plans to turn over the nation's atomic fuel industry to private businesses now hold top jobs in the private nuclear energy industry. President Ford, following the initiative of President Nixon, is currently pressuring Congress to pass a White House bill that would put private corporations in control of the government's multi-billion-dollar uranium fuel-making industry. Newsday says that George Shultz, the former director of the Office of Management and Budget, was one of the central figures responsible for implementing Nixon's uranium fuel-making plans. Shultz today is president of the Bechtel Corporation, a California firm which heads up a consortium of companies, now completing negotiations for government guarantees of more than $3.5 billion to get into the uranium business. Casper Weinberger, who served as director to Shultz while Nixon's uranium plans were being developed, is working for Bechtel as special counsel. Newsday adds that two other new employees of the Bechtel Corporation, coincidentally, are Robert Hollingsworth and Peter Flanagan. Hollingsworth is a former chief exec with the Atomic Energy Commission, and Flanagan is a former assistant to the president whose primary role was as a liaison man with government agencies, including the AEC. Police in Como, Italy, after secret investigations, have sealed off and uprooted 3,000 marijuana plants, which were being grown, believe it or not, for chicken feed. 65-year-old Celeste Maspero complained that the police had confiscated all of his chicken feed, saying he'd been growing the pot plant for years, then threshing them out for seeds. Police say that Maspero apparently had never been aware that the seeds were considerably desirable by anyone but the chickens.
Yeah, let's get to that. Well, there's only a little bit of sports. I'll only mention one thing in the world of sports, and that's that the Minnesota Gophers lost in hockey last night, WCHA competition, to Michigan State, but they'll get some of their own back later on that, I'm sure. U100, WIO, AM and FM Stereo, Ridgefield, reminds you, help out the U.S. Marine Corps. U100 Toy for Tots campaign this Christmas season. Put any usable toys that you don't need in the barrels at any Twin City 7-Eleven store. Give the kids who need it most something to celebrate this Christmas. U100, save the seal, Chicago weekend type weather for the Twin Cities. The low this morning should be around 6 degrees, possibly. A high today under mostly sunny skies, probably around 28, then back down around 10. Tonight, right down to Super U, it's clear and 15 degrees. I'm Art Snow. U100 presents our Thanksgiving turkey to you one day early. Joan and Super U present Frank Zappa Wednesday night, 8 o'clock, St. Paul Civic Center. From Joan and U100, the station with the concerts. Moontan LP, Golden Earrings, Radar Love. Snowman, this is a Chicago weekend. Plays and giveaways all weekend long of Chicago, the very best of Chicago. This is one of the best of Chicago. U100 Chicago weekend weather. A low of 6, high of 28. Mostly sunny today. Low of 10 tonight. Right now, 15 clear. Barry Manilow. I write the song. U100 Manilow. He is music. He writes the song. 424 in the Twin Cities. Barry White by request.
I've heard people say that.
U100 wants you to help a kid, and why not otherwise have anything to celebrate? Bring any new or slightly used toy to any Twin City 7-Eleven store, put it in the barrel, give it to the U100 U.S. Marine Corps Toy for Tots campaign. My request from Energize, Foghat, Honey Hush. U100 is Snowman. Good morning. 438 at Twin Cities, 15 degrees, Black Oak, Arkansas, from X-Rated. Strong enough to be gentle. U100 100 Stereo. War. Me and baby brother. Jerry Slick James this morning, 6 o'clock on the Super U. And Rex King telling you why it's going to be so cold. ABBA. 100-450 the Super U, Snowman, Charlie Daniels Band, Birmingham Blues. U-100, 9 o'clock this morning, Brother Bob on the Super U. From Red Octopus, Jefferson Starship, Miracles. 100 Chicago Weekend with Snowman. Good morning. 5:05 in the Twin Cities, 14 degrees. And U-100 will present the BBC Rolling Stone Concert Special, Sunday night at 10. Right on Super U. And the main course LP, BG. U-100, 509 in the Twin Cities. The Snowman for Chicago Weekend. By request from the Dark Side of the Moon LP. Me and our janitorial really want to hear this. Makes you feel so good. Big Floyd money. U-100, Snowman on a Chicago weekend. Plays and giveaways all weekend long. Chicago LPs and other album instant rips. I'll have something for you coming up within minutes on the Super U. Be ready for it. Chicago. Been searching so long. U-100 Snowman, 6 o'clock this morning. Jerry St. James, the world's original cheapskate. Tell you about the good time he had last night. Olivia. U-100. 5,000 volts. I'm on fire. News time once again at U-100. We'll have in a moment.
Here is the director.
In the news this morning. The White House says President Ford abhors involvement of government officials in assassination plots, but he refuses to pass judgment on the actions of past administrations. The statements yesterday came one day after the Senate Intelligence Committee reported on a series of unsuccessful plots by the CIA to assassinate foreign leaders. Henry Kissinger said the CIA can be prevented from such plots in the future, but the agency should not be stripped of all its covert activities. The White House also said the president sees nothing in the Senate report to warrant dismissal of Kissinger or Richard Helms, a former CIA director and now ambassador of Iran. The report indicates Kissinger and Helms were implicated in U.S.-supported opposition to Chilean President Allende and the earlier murder of Chilean General René Schneider. Charging that amendments were perverting the spirit of the proposal, the United States has withdrawn its U.N. resolution calling for worldwide amnesty for political prisoners. A U.S. delegate said the measure could wind up asking for amnesty only for political terrorists. The Cuban ambassador said the U.S. was trying to preach to fellow U.N. members. New York state legislators were fighting over nuisance taxes and higher income levies that would make New York City residents dig into their pockets for an extra $205 million last night. Both houses of New York state legislature are prepared for early morning sessions to complete action on the city taxes. They're being upheld by the long debate of angry New York City council members speaking in special session. Lynette Frohm said she will decide by Monday whether to end her courtroom boycott and testify on her own behalf at her trial on charges of attempting to assassinate President Ford. She was brought into the courtroom Friday, but she refused to answer Judge Thomas McBride's questions about whether she would testify. She said she'll decide over the weekend. Ronald Reagan stopped in key primary states yesterday in the second day of his campaign for the Republican presidential nomination. The former California governor started the day in New Hampshire, then traveled to North Carolina and his native Illinois before returning home to California. In his various speeches, Reagan said he does not want, quoting here, 4 more years of business as usual in Washington. Minnesota residents are digging out from under up to 24 inches of snow that fell throughout the state Thursday, and travel remains a problem in certain areas. No travel advisories were in effect yesterday for the Wilmer and Marshall areas, where 17 inches of snow fell.
Highways there were blocked and stalled vehicles hampered cleanup operations. In the Twin Cities, city streets were clogged with 7 inches of wet snow. Residential streets went unplowed. According to Lauren Seavey, superintendent of street maintenance, the city engineer will decide Monday about plowing the residential streets. It's a matter of money, Seavey said, adding, we're hoping for a mild winter. So what? The death of 65-year-old George Cooley of Heron Lake raised to 6 the number of Minnesotans known to have died as a result of Thursday's winter storm. Authorities say Cooley was found 20 feet from his Jackson County home. He is believed to have suffered a heart attack and died of exposure. 4 of the deaths in the state were attributed to heart attacks, and a Huron, South Dakota man apparently died of exposure near Worthington. In sports, Michigan State down Minnesota 3-1 last night in a Western Collegiate Hockey Association game in East Lansing, Michigan. Steve Kolb got his 12th goal of the year in the third period to power the Spartans to the win. Center Tom Vanelli registered Minnesota's only goal in the third period. Minnesota's now 3-2 in the league, 6-2 overall. At Duluth, North Dakota State University edged Minnesota Duluth 5-4 in another WCHA game. In other WCHA games, Michigan shut out Michigan Tech 4-0 at Ann Arbor, and Notre Dame defeated Denver 5-2, and Colorado College edged Wisconsin.